listening to the What the Hell Show and those sick individuals we call DJs on Ranch Radio.
Speak in your mic. It's about the only way I'm going to hear you with this music playing in the background.
Sorry. We've started.
We've started.
Are we on the air now?
It's what we're on the air.
Can they hear me speaking?
No, there's music playing. Oh.
Holy Christ on a bike! It's Sunday night at 9 p.m. It's time for the What the Hell Show with Private Drek's Old Sumerian. Join in
that
on
I'd
the
like
conversation
to hear
on the IRC on the Ranch Radio channel and the Dalnet servers. And now here's Private Drexel.
No, it isn't. You lie.
There is no Private Drexel. Go home. Thank you. Come again.
We're not on yet.
Here we are. Now we're
You
on.
Lie! There is no Private Drexel.
There is no Private Drexel. This week, due to some circumstances we don't know about.
There is no fucking spoon. Shut up.
But we do have Sean Kennedy this
we
week.
We do.
Who is a special guest here.
As to filling in for the annoyance factor. He'll do his best.
What the fuck, man? Like, what the hell? Oh, I didn't show for the What the Hell Show, but I record rants all the time, and I'm probably actually on the air more than anybody else because I'm in rotation.
Hey, apparently,
my
stories are going
into
rotation, too.
That's right.
Yes, that's
He's
true.
He's being published.
Oh, fuck. Anyways, hey, everybody. How you doing? Who's all in the house?
Not too many people. I don't know.
There's a fucking
Lieutenant
switch.
Major Zombie.
Hi, Lieutenant Major Zombie.
Yes, you're here again.
You know, it really pisses me off that he's like the only guy who's loyal, and he's a fucking idiot.
No.
Be nice.
There's more, like, Lynn Faloop is here a lot.
There's quite a few. Actually, that's not really fair. Lieutenant Major Zombie isn't a fucking idiot. He's just got some issues. Okay,
Stop picking on the boy.
What?
Stop. Picking on the boy. We are like so brutal to this kid. He's like,
obviously. How old is he?
16.
How old
15,
are
16.
Are you 15?
Like, yes.
You should stop listening to me right now. I swear way too much to talk to any 15-year-old. Yeah, we killed Drexel. I'm eating him right now, actually. It's like that scene from Rocky Horror Picture Show, you know?
Yep. Chowing down on Drexel.
Drexel had really good
it's
taste.
It's our strange.
16.
Oh, you're 16.
Is your mic on? I don't think your mic is on. Girl
turn
on the
turn
left.
Your little turn
girl
your little
on the left is here.
Hello.
There we go.
Your woman's
excellent.
In the house.
Excuse me.
Oh, nothing. He's just having a masturbational fantasy. Don't worry about it. Leave him alone. Pull harder. Pull
knife,
harder.
You know.
What's that? I'm not. Lieutenant Major Zombie's having weird little fantasies.
Well, Pixie Chick has joined us.
Who's Pixie Chick?
A new person.
Hello, new person.
She's dropped into the IRC
wait,
once
wait,
in a while.
Wait. We might actually know this woman, so everybody be very cool.
In Manitoba?
It's possible.
On the wave?
On the wave in Manitoba. Pixie Chick.
Named who, Adrian, possibly?
Well, I knew a guy named Adrian, unless he had...
It's changed a bit.
Hello, Pixie Chick. Welcome to the show.
So, I am not dumb.
No, you're not dumb. You're absolutely right. You spelt that totally correct. Way to
he
go.
Did. He did.
He did. He spelt that correct.
Okay, in
I
the...
stand correct. Eek. Hi, Pixie Chick. Can you hear us, Pixie Chick? If so...
Just
type
no
something.
She's probably freaking out that she heard her name on the radio. She's been dropping in from time to time this week on the IRC, and she's been listening in. But I think this is her first time on What the Hell.
Well, let's find out her age. How old are you, Pixie Chick?
Is it a her? Yes, Adrian. Okay, how old are you? See if you fit in our age demographic of 15-year-olds.
Great. I'm sure they're touching themselves and thinking of the woolly projectile vomit man as we speak. Incidentally, on that note, what's with the Grizzly Adams motif? Forgot to shave, things went bad, didn't wash, what happened? No. Just give him the mic so we can hear what he has to say.
Too fucking lazy to shave.
Wow, now that's apathy in action. Brian, suppose you want to take a shit or something? No, I'm just lying in bed here.
Pixie Chick is 21.
21,
we have a legal adult on the air.
That's amazing, even in the States, a legal adult.
She
could drink and everything, except she's in Canada.
She could be lying through her fucking teeth,
too. We don't care.
Yeah, that's true.
I have something even scarier. He could be lying through his fucking teeth.
Yeah. Incidentally, you don't have... Just in case you are lying to...
We don't care.
Have to worry about it. No.
There's no
minimum
here.
Age here.
Yeah. Just prepare to
what
be
are we
offended.
Gonna do? Say goodbye or say goodbye again. You know,
hey,
like,
Enki's here. Enki, you want to get on the camera? While you're here, don't trip on the mic cord.
Enki spoken.
So we have NextNet, Shazbot, InfoLoop, Morth, Loop, Morchith.
Loop. Mord Sith. Next net.
Less
Mord. Chazbort.
Pixie Chick and Chazbort, yep.
Well, welcome to our cast. Please stop that.
So if you're listening and your name wasn't called out, you can get your name called out.
You can.
If you go to our webpage and click on chat and fill in your name and press connect, and you'll be up here in our list, and you can see what all these people are saying about us.
And what we're saying.
Yes, push that in now.
I believe you picked a chick that you're not lying.
Yeah. It'll go down. There you go. And just press the red button.
Okay, here we go. Mord Sith hates shaving. Mord Sith is 18. Infaloop is 19. Lieutenant Major Zombie is 16. And Chazbot, I'm 15.
So our average age
Chazbot is the winner.
18.
And next net is 19.
I want to get a 5-year-old on here.
If our demographic keeps shifting like this, we might actually have to start using less sophomoric humor.
Yeah, we might.
Damn, there goes half the night show.
No.
That'll require effort and stuff.
That's right. What we can do actually is, because these kids are actually, they're giving me a break. Most 15 and 6-year-olds now who actually are on the show are pretty intelligent kids.
You know, most of them.
Even Lieutenant Major's.
That was a very nice lick up. That was.
No, it wasn't a lick up. I mean, shit, they're sitting there. They're
no. The camera. Let's go around the room.
We're going around the room. Enki.
No.
Enki.
No.
Enki, get on the fucking camera.
Tempting fate.
We threw a cracker.
Someday, somehow, you will wake up to a cracker.
And it won't be in your face.
It'll have your name on
it. You'll pull your covers back, and there will be nothing but crackers. There won't be a bed.
Crackers!
I will have spit on crackers and molded them into a bed-like shape.
That made my life right there. I just got you dead between the eyes with that cracker.
Good thing he's wearing glasses.
Actually, it's a good thing, yeah.
Okay, we're going to go around the room and see who's here this week. And as always, no, start on this.
Projectile
vomit, man. Give him a mic. Give that man a mic. Oh my god.
Really fucking loud.
In a little closer.
That was Projectile Vomit Man, 200% sexy Projectile Vomit Man.
That's right. Yeah. And next up, we have a girl on the left. And a big wave and silence from girl on the left.
Speak, girl on the left.
Speak.
Woo.
What?
You're not supposed to hear me. Speak.
He's
say
off
hi.
Hello.
There we go.
Look at the camera. Now look at me. Look like you're enjoying it. Okay, yeah. That's good. Yeah.
Move her hair.
Stop it.
Next up, we have Black Wolf, who's reading a paper.
Reading a very good paper, actually. It's got a really pretty picture on the back.
We suck, really. Wow.
You might want to zoom in a little closer on that.
I might.
Yeah. Zoom way in. Zoom in.
And those things are ridiculous.
No, they're not.
There you go. Just hits. There we go.
Okay, and next
That's
up
sex
we have.
Appeal. What's that?
What is your name?
Does she come with the car?
There's a car?
I bet she comes, though. Who cares if she comes? It's your job to get off.
Selfish.
Oh, thrombach.
Next up we have Sean Kennedy.
Sean, the man.
Effing man.
This is true. Me and my fatness are spilling myself onto this desk here, and that's about it.
And next up we have
Dak. Hi.
Big wave. Got the wave in.
With the living hair.
Hi.
That's pretty big this week.
Dak and the living hair. You really have to get a crew cut. You'd look so much like, you know, one of those guys on America's Most Wanted.
And next up we have
I think we talked about Sumerian.
The most photogenic man in the world.
Hello out there.
Hello.
My name is Sumerian.
You are.
And I host this show.
You are.
Yes.
Yes.
And Drexel is not here this week.
Yes, we're
and neither is the Dark Drexel One, which is why I'm being as vile as I possibly can
the
be.
The Dark One isn't here, and neither is the chicken. We are sans chicken.
We are chickenless, chicken
free. And finally we have...
Enki.
Trying to rub
the sexiest pedophile on internet radio.
Wow, I wouldn't even make that joke myself. Just for future reference, if Enki actually was a pedophile, I'd wade into him with a shave down 2x4.
You'd shave it down?
On his head.
Only for the grip. That's about it. We have no pedophiles on the show.
Nope. We're pedophile-less.
We are pedophile-free.
And trust me, in Canada, with our wonderful laws, that's very hard. Because remember, it's legal for 14 and up.
Yep. And you can possess any pictures you want.
For 14, I was under the impression that it was like the age was 14 if the person that you were with was 18 or under.
No.
Okay, if I'm not a pedophile, where are we targeting this demographic?
recruitment, is it? Is that your angle? filth.
It is now literally 14 and up is legal.
Yay!
This woman tried to get this man arrested. He was 27. He was sleeping with her 14-year-old daughter.
Uh-huh.
And there was nothing they could do about it thanks to the new law.
Oh. Here's one thing he could have done. He could have called us.
Yes, we would have been happy to take care of it for them.
Oh, I understand you're sleeping with my 14-year-old daughter. I'm going to cave in your head now. Thank you. Further bulletins as events warrant.
What the fuck?
Play the pedophile rant?
There's various groups that are trying to get it increased, but I mean...
Play the pedophile. Who asked for the pedophile rant? Who just asked for that?
That was...
Who was that?
Oh, my computer's being slow again. Infoloop.
Infoloop.
Infoloop. You actually know, like, all of my rants or what? That surprises the shit out of me.
It frightens
Sean
me.
Sean K.
It does. It scares the fuck out of me. Some guy actually
he's stalking
to all my rants and remembers them. Wow. Okay, Infoloop is now the coolest guy on Rant Radio.
Where is the pedophile one? I think that's in the old ones.
Children, what's that? No.
Children, child porn. No? Yeah.
That's it.
Child porn. So here is Sean K. and his opinion on child pornography.
There we go.
Once again, here's Sean Kennedy, the fucking man, on Rant Radio.
Okay, it's child pornography time. Yeah, we're going to talk about the good old child porn that exists on the net. Recently, laws were just passed in BC that said it's okay to have child porn. Federally and by the law, you're allowed to look at little pictures of little six-year-olds hanging their dicks out and abuse children. NAMBLA, the North American Man-Boy Love Association. Real organization. Look it up. With any effort, get a membership list. Find out who's a member of that thing. Then go to their homes and burn the fucking things down. If you find people out there, Sean Kennedy says, kill pedophiles. That's right, don't maim those motherfuckers. Kill them dead. Kill them. Take them out in the street. Put a pickaxe right between their fucking head. You like that? Have another one. Yeah, it's good to go. You know you love it. You know it's good. It's natural selection. It's the right thing to do. It's like porridge and sex. You go, eat some porridge, have some sex, go kill yourself a pedophile, and giggle about it while you sleep. Do you really think there's a jury on this planet that would convict you? I myself could snipe Clifford Olson, and I would get a fucking handshake and a key to the city. Give me a break. Nobody likes child porn, so if you're a child pornographer and you're listening to this radio station, first of all, hide. That little red dot that's circling around your head, yeah, that's somebody from Rant Radio, and they want your fucking nuts on a platter. They ought to do, like Dennis Leary said, man, put you in a city square with a big sandwich sign on your stark naked body that says, I carry a torch for kids who carry candles. It's a fucking fact. You are a moron, you're a sick piece of shit, and the kindest thing you could possibly do for society to remove yourself for your sins is to go get your whole head in front of the shotgun and just squeeze off around. And if you don't have the nuts to do it, you can contact me at www.rantradio.com because my name is Sean Kennedy and I am the fucking man.
That was Sean Kennedy.
So apparently Pixie Chick has some information about Gary Glitter.
Yes, Gary Glitter was took his computer in to get repaired. He didn't remove the pictures. He's the
Gary
guy who makes that song, Rock and Roll Part 2, that's played at
hockey games. Hey!
Why am I so... glam rocker from the 70s.
Where's my picture? I was just working like 20 minutes.
Okay, so he took his computer in, and he didn't take his little pictures off his computer. So he got promptly arrested and thrown in jail.
How many pictures did he have?
I don't know. Tons and tons. So he got lots and lots of charges.
Oh, did he? Okay, now...
People do stupid stuff when they're trying to bring in their computers for repair. Like there was a computer thief in Langley last year, and they stole a bunch of computers and they brought them in to get them traded without actually wiping the hard drives.
Now, just on that,
who does this belong to?
Just on that Gary Glitter thing, this is my
surprise.
There's
a little bit more about that too.
As I understand it, okay, the guy goes, he's got some photos of kids on his internet on his hard drive. Now we don't actually know what the photos are. Okay,
they're of kids.
Pedophiles are the new witch, right?
Yeah.
You just scream pedophile and everybody shoots the motherfucker, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I have nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong here at all. There's a lot right about killing pedophiles. Okay, there's a lot good with that. But check your fire. Make sure your target is accurate, right?
Yep.
This guy, maybe he's got a bunch of, and I also have a bit of a problem. If you're a pedophile, to be a pedophile, you have to assault children. If you're turned on by kids, okay, you've got a real fucking problem, and you deserve a beating anyway. Maybe not a pick, but you deserve a beating.
But you're not a thought criminal. You're not going to go after him because he thinks.
However, I have a real problem with you possess this photograph, so you must die.
Mm-hmm.
I have a problem with that.
Okay. Well, that's human being.
So you agree with the law then,
in
BC?
I'm Now, the thing, it's never as simple as the law, okay? It's never as simple as the law. Like, well, you can have that. Like, if he's, you know, jerking off to pictures of five-year-old naked kids, on principle, he needs to be killed.
Okay? Yeah, why was a computer repairman looking at the pictures on his computer? Because we do that.
Because they do that and they snoop.
We need entertainment.
But the point is, it's like, okay, so the guy's got hordes of, if he had, like, hordes of pedophile shit, that's one thing. But what's to say that he's like, let's just destroy Gary Glitter by planting some, you want to go have some, have a good time and fuck people over? Go get a hard drive full of internet child porn.
Mm-hmm.
Go get a hard drive full of it. It's only, what, 5 inches by an inch and a half by 4 inches?
Yep.
Put it in a guy's house. Report him as a guy exploiting child porn. Mail it to him. He has it in his house.
Yep.
Cops kick in the door. There's a hard drive loaded with porn. Instant witch, you're fucked for life.
But that's just part of the wonderful laws we have here in Canada. Like, for instance, there was a law that was recently passed called 63 or 64B.
Mm-hmm.
It has to do with guns. Basically, in Canada now...
64C.
64C, thank you. Yeah. 64C, if you have a firearm in your home, an illegal firearm, the police no longer need a warrant.
No, if they think you have...
Let me finish. I was going to preface that with the word... Now, all this requires is suspicion. Suspicion includes somebody called up, said your name, and said you have an illegal gun, and the police now have the right, without receiving a warrant, without checking this with a judge, to kick in your door... and search your property.
Really?
And
just
by
for
the way,
possessing it, not
and
using
and
it
also, or... here's the other really great part. Any other crimes or materials they find in that search is now admissible evidence.
That's a great loophole.
Now,
I like that one.
Let's think of who it is we're likely to run into in common day to day, you know, walking around, that's going to have a lot of illegal weapons handy that they can take with them. That would be the cops. Now, it's really cool to watch television shows and see, oh, it's the good cop. He's going to fuck the criminal over and get him.
Yeah.
But the problem is, the cop can walk into your house carrying nothing but a stolen 9mm in his back pocket, and they're not hard to come by, and search your house, tear everything apart, and, oh, look what I found. Now, you might be thinking, Derek, you're a little bit unrealistic here. You're thinking the cops are all corrupt and bad things can happen. I don't actually think the police are all corrupt. I like a lot of cops.
Yeah, they taste like chicken.
I've met some really nice cops, but... the problem is, this is a law
and
which
you got
begs
sober.
To be exploited. Begs to be exploited. This law is
that's
giving them
for.
An open door. That's why we have warrants, is so the cops can't do things like this.
Yeah.
And never, ever should you have a situation where a cop can do anything without a warrant coming into your house.
Yes, exactly.
Anyways, I'm done ranting. Bye
now. Yep.
Talking about that, there's a story. Now, this is actually taken from the TV series Homicide, Life on the Streets, but it was actually passed on to them by some officers of the Baltimore Police Force. Now, this is old-time cops, so we are talking. It's gotten a lot better, but apparently the story goes, cops are chasing a drug dealer down into, just a petty criminal, down into some alleyway. The guy turns around and basically pulls out, or they thought he turned around to basically face them. They shot him.
Yay.
Now, the cops all reach into their back pocket as one, not really thinking about it, and toss down a knife. So there's about half a dozen knives all laying down around this guy. And basically, the crook looks around and goes, one of them reaches down, picks up one of the knives, goes, here's his knife. Now, they all start laughing at this, at which point they hear from the Vic that they just shot, that's not my knife, that's my knife. This is cop humor.
Yeah, well, it goes something like this. See, that's why you go get yourself an old microwave oven, and you make a little slot in the top of the microwave oven, and you get your UPS that you have, and you plug the microwave oven into the UPS, and you plug your computer into the UPS, and you have removable hard drives that you pay an extra, what is it, $20 to get removable hard drive mounting? Is that what it is now?
Yep.
Then what you do is you have that all plugged in, and you have the on button for 5 minutes. You then case the whole works in like a Lexan plastic or something really hard. Or, yeah, that would probably work. Then when the cops kick in the doors, you have all your pirate CDs and everything in there. When the cops kick in the doors, you pull out your hard drive, you drop it in the microwave, you hit the panic button, and walk. Your CDs are readable, and your hard drive is bad now. Because even if they fucking chop cords and pull plugs, it'll probably be a couple of minutes before they can get that goddamn hard drive out of there.
Apparently, and imagine this, Lieutenant Major Zombie got kicked out of school.
Oh, really?
Our calm boy, like Lieutenant Major Zombie.
You got kicked out of school? Why'd you get kicked out of school?
Oh.
He probably made a joke about killing his schoolmates.
Probably.
He probably wore the wrong shade of...
wrote a
trench coat.
He wore a Pepsi shirt on Coke Day.
Yes, that's.
He didn't. He removed the logo from his tag.
That's yeah. Right.
What? You did,
did,
Pepsi?
Did you tear the label off a mattress, kid? What? For hacking.
Further on the Gary Glitter thing.
Oh yes, that wonderful catch-all phrase, hacking.
A lot of the hockey.
What did you do?
I'm sorry.
Okay,
but
a lot of the hockey
hacking,
places have
boy,
stopped using his song.
They've yeah. stopped oh,
just because
God.
Of that. Isn't that
well,
stupid?
Was he really hacking?
Oh,
was he really hacking, or was he just goofing around and he got busted for goofing around?
Well, that's just it. It's like hacking can be
teachers
anything.
Don't know.
Like,
hey,
doing things with the computer the teacher doesn't know how to do. In a lot of schools, that's hacking.
School paper. What the fuck is this?
Oh, pinball.
Pinball. That's not hacking.
Well, no. Tell the teachers that.
What is this?
Chris will lose computer privileges for 10 days. December 7th to December 20th, Chris will be...
something.
Allowed to make up work missed during this time. Circumvented two security features and told another student how to do the same.
Whoa. Why did you just play pinball?
Is that what he did?
Spoke with mother.
Expelled for playing pinball.
For 7 days. You weren't kicked out of school, man. You got suspended for 7 fucking days.
7 days.
Still.
7 days for a bloody game of pinball.
Yeah.
Your school is just a little paranoid.
But the point is, they said it was bypassing two security
okay.
features.
Lieutenant Major Zombie?
What security features? The password?
Yeah.
Okay, Lieutenant Major Zombie. Now, I am not saying that you should do this. This is what you don't want to do. You don't want to do this. You don't want to harbor a grudge. You don't want to wait until the end of the year. That would be bad to wait until the end of the year.
This would be hypothetically very bad thing
no,
to do.
No, it's bad to wait till the end of the year because then you wouldn't be able to be disciplined at the end of the year. Whatever you do, Lieutenant Major Zombie, do the right thing. Just forgive them. Do the Christian thing. Don't go buy yourself a powerful electromagnet. Don't do that. Okay. And
slowly walk along the
and
computers.
And whatever you do, do not walk around over... The computers with it. I mean, that's wrong. It's a wrong thing to do, man.
Another thing
you don't want to do is you don't want to get a floppy disk. You don't want to install just DOS on it. Nothing but DOS. You don't want to write an autoexec bat file, which has one line, which is format space C colon.
They could put a password
on
the CMOS.
You do not want to write on that disk. Do not insert in computer and reboot.
They could put a password on the CMOS.
Yeah,
you have to open
yeah.
it up to
another
play
thing
the
you
jumpers.
Don't want to do, and this is something that the teachers at my school learned the hard way, is that now we had a computer room that had carpeting on the floor. But you don't what you don't want to do is you don't want to build up a nice lovely charge before you touch the computer every time.
over and over.
The nice little pins back there, you don't want to touch those when it's got
yeah,
the
no, that's
charge.
Bad. So
that's my system.
Forgive them all. Just forgive them and move on.
As far as I'm concerned, you don't want to mix a gallon of basically nitromethane.
Oh, 55%. Hey, the kid's 15,
all right? Fuck. No. You don't want to get him kicked out of chemistry class, too.
You don't want to mix ammonia and bleach for extra fizzy clean.
Hey, there's a good idea.
Oh, no.
No, you don't want to fucking do that.
Make sure
you'll gas yourself.
Make sure you basically, when you do that, you don't want to be around breathing. And we really mean you don't want to be around breathing.
No, that generates chlorine gas. You know, there's stuff they killed soldiers in the trenches with in World War I.
Yeah, like, don't do that. Like...
It's time for the news.
Time for news.
It's now time for the news and web pages of the week. If you have an interesting news item or web page, send it to me, Sumerian, at ICQ number 51558. And now for the news of the week.
Laughing.
Laughing my ass off.
Ah, okay.
Laughing my ass off. So the first story is hundreds called for jury duty in 1900. As many as 500 Pennsylvanians got notices telling them to show up for jury duty in 1900, an error caused by the so-called Y2K bug in city court computers.
Aha! It strikes.
Mm-hmm. And one of the guys who got it says, I told my wife, I've got jury duty, but I can't go. I've already missed it. And I told her it was in for the year 1900. About 400 to 500 people got it.
I had a can of pop, which was Y2K non-compliant. It's actually on my homepage. It says on the bottom, it says, you know, best before May 1900. I drank it anyways. I live on the edge.
It was a real
You're such
can.
A risk taker.
Yes, I know.
That'd be awesome to hang on to.
My dad hijacked the can, unfortunately.
I managed to convince two kids at the...
Do you want to tell a story?
What story?
I'm just kidding.
I managed to basically convince two kids, you bastard. He's got that. I'm slow tonight.
Structural integrity man. Right on.
Hey, how you doing, structural integrity man? Anyhow, like I said, I managed to convince two kids at work that basically about Y2K is actually going to happen. And I know they're 16 years old. But is
it
like
in the Nike ad? You know it's going to happen then.
Has anyone seen that? That is beautiful.
That is such a good ad.
I love.
I haven't seen it. I've only seen a few pictures.
The apocalyptic IBM ad.
Yeah. That's just.
It's not IBM. It's a.
No, IBM. Sorry. Nike.
I've Nike. Seen it, Starbucks sued over alleged crushed penis. How the fuck do you allege a crushed penis?
Very ashamed. It was a Canadian tourist. A Canadian tourist who claims that his penis was crushed by a faulty toilet seat at Starbucks.
Oh, I know how that happened.
It's one of those toupee
you do?
Things. Oh. It's one of those toilet toupees.
Yep.
Maybe he's just short.
Has sued the... giant coffee retailer for $1.5 million, his attorney said.
Our client,
Edward Squarek,
That's about the sound he made when it hit. Squarek!
Was in a seated position on the toilet when he turned to retrieve the toilet paper in back of the seat when the seat shifted, causing his penis to be caught and crushed between the seat and the bowl.
Oh, I hope
Richard
he wasn't
Robbins.
A heavy man.
These guys are a bunch of dicks. They've gone and said his name and where he lives and everything. Fuck.
Oh, he's filing a
I'm
lawsuit.
I'm sure the Starbucks employees are directly responsible for this.
Oh, yeah, probably.
Well, and the man should be able to figure out how to use a toilet seat.
Well, no, here's a question. Was the toilet seat basically loose so that, like, when he turned around, did the thing...
I know.
When I'm using public toilets, I always rest my cock on the bowl, like the nice messy bowl where everybody else has been peeing, you know, underneath the seat so I can get all the splashback, too. I think that's great. I always do that.
Yeah, it's all kinds of good. It's just a bit farther.
It gets way better. It gets way better.
Swarik seeks $1 million in damage and his wife $500,000 is because she has been deprived of his services.
Hey, baby, I got news for you, Squarek. If you haven't got it in the hips, you better have it in the lips, baby. Okay?
It's been 3 months since it happened to the lawsuit. So he is worth about $150,000 a month. Wow,
okay,
he is
damn
good.
That, yeah,
holy crap.
Divide that by how you know, try to figure out how often
day.
They do it. You can probably say, you know, she could hire somebody.
Yeah.
Actually, they say
hire many people.
After you've been married a while, you do it 3 times a week is what the average is.
Uh-huh.
They worked that out.
Okay.
So let's see what's
So if we really got it down to it.
3 months?
3 months. $500,000, 3 months.
So, and it's 3 times a week. So,
500,000 divided by 3
times 12. 3 is 108.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. 500,000.
Where do they get these guys' fucking names? Like Squarek and Gulick and all these guys. I'm Alan Gulick. Sorry about your luck.
I think all this stuff's just generated by a CGI.
I think so too.
Like, what the hell?
Gulick.
That's 46,000.
Every time?
Yeah, 46,000 a time.
Wow. Lady, I got news for you.
He's damn
you know
good.
What you can get for $46,000?
Oh, sorry, $4,628. It's like $5,000. $5,000 a time.
$5,000
for fuck.
Hello. Starbucks Insurance just crunched the numbers and figure out the average price of a gigolo and offer them that much.
Well, if it's a really good gigolo, $5,000 is not out of control.
Drex isn't here. Get away, Doc.
I was filling in.
Hi, you're on Rant Radio. Who is this?
Lieutenant Major Zombie.
Hey, Lieutenant Major Zombie.
It's too early to call, kid.
Do you have something to say, maybe about your probation?
Oh, yeah. It was called a Fortress. It was a $300 program.
I think I've heard of that, Fortress.
Did you break it?
Went around it.
Went around it?
So that's all. You went around it, and because you went around it, you got kicked out.
Yeah, I got kicked out for 2 days, and I got spending butt.
You should have alerted them to their poor security first. And then that would make an even better story.
You should have fucked them in the mouth is what you should have done. Whatever.
Two things.
Yes.
One thing was bad, one thing was good.
Okay, yeah, this has been stimulating, but bye now.
Goodbye.
Okay, we're going to say bye-bye. You phone in later. Say what the hell.
Huh?
Yeah. Close enough. Huh?
Okay. The kid's smarter than that.
We did that because it's really not call-in time yet.
It's not call-in time.
Like, you are so lucky that Drex is not here. He'd fucking have your ass on the plane.
Yeah, you'd be gone before he even said anything. So this next one is, let's see. Jesus is really dreading his next birthday.
Why?
Jesus Christ, Son of God and Savior of humanity, confided Monday that he is not looking forward to his 2000th birthday next year, saying that he's really dreading turning the big 2000. This is the big one, says Christ, who will be turning 1999 December 25th. I can't believe I'm actually turning 2000 soon. I'm seriously getting up there. Though his associates have been keeping him in good company as the milestone draws near, Christ said he's finding it increasingly difficult to keep his spirits up.
They this keep telling is me really, really this is from the not Onion. Funny. It's amazing.
Yeah, okay.
Not funny.
They can read this themselves, Sam. All okay. In favor of just moving on.
Moving all on.
Okay, good next. Picture, though.
Okay, that's cute.
It's fucking fab. All right, let's move on. Next, terrorist bomb not to because why is this all this Onion shit on here?
Well, he likes the Onion. And funny. Sometimes they have had good stuff, but I have to say that that's just
like
really.
Jesus turning 2000, not liking it. An action-packed bomb did not go off.
Terrorist bomb not defused in thrilling, suspense-packed final minutes. An action-packed chase through the subway tunnels beneath London's famed Victoria Station, culminating in a climactic, pulse-pounding fight sequence atop a double-decker bus did not occur Monday, when a terrorist bomb exploded crowded downtown bus after not being defused at the very last moment. The bomb, which killed 22 and seriously injuring 30 more, ranks amongst the worst incidents of terrorism to hit London in years, which was not presented in THX Digital Surround Sound. That's it, scum. Now it's time to take out the trash, a grim-faced CIA agent who had been working closely with a team of Britain's top anti-terrorist expert did not say moments before defeating the leader of a mysterious terrorist organization in a deadly, desperate encounter atop the speeding bus. It was horrible, just horrible, a visibly shaken Edith Nesbitt, 38, a London homemaker who is 12-year-old.
It's yeah, we
no
get...
No. You get the irony already?
Yeah, we get the irony. There's a lot of irony. It's like, it's
this is funny as fuck. Can we move on? I'm dying over here.
Okay.
No, I None think we that. All are.
Pirate gets probation? What?
We'll do this one first.
Scary Microsoft agreement. Is this Onion or is this real?
Oh, it's not Onion. That was and it's gone.
He's whining.
Yeah,
God damn it.
I thought this was
this
gone.
This one is good.
Yeah, what it was can I just explain what it was? Because I was actually using this on, I was actually trying to use this one as a reference on one of my papers. I may have actually listed it as a reference on one of the papers I was working on for school this week. It was a Microsoft agreement, the little sort of shrink wrap license, right? And it was basically saying that by opening the package, you were agreeing to the terms of the agreement. The agreement, of course, you could not read until you unwrapped the package, slipped it into your hard disk drive, and read it.
Yep.
So, in other words, you're agreeing to
shit before you open it.
Yeah, you're basically agreeing to the license terms, whatever the hell they are. You know, you could be promising Microsoft your firstborn, okay?
You like, have to stick to it.
Agreements.
Like, can you give me a fucking break, please?
Okay, so, yeah, that's like, is there's actually, like, I mean, the big thing with these shrimp rock licenses is that most of the time, like...
You just tear them off.
Well, yeah, it's just like, there, it's...
Crunch all you want, we'll make more.
The whole question is, I don't think they can legally hold you to that. It's not, they can't make you sign an agreement or do the equivalent of signing an agreement without actually being able to read the agreement, because part of the terms of the agreement, I was under the impression, was that, you know, I fully understand the terms of this agreement.
Girl on the left, I have a bit of a shocker for you. Everybody hates the consumer. There is no law. It's a myth. It's just lawyers fucking over other people. So they can do whatever they please, which is why you need to own a gun.
I saw a wonderful comedic thing. It was the 40th anniversary of George Carlin since he started in comedy. He's been around for 40 years. He's him, Lenny Bruce, and Richard Pryor consider the holy trinity of comedy. And Carlin's new skit was nothing more than basically describing advertising for those of us who don't speak advertisees. It's all bullshit. Doesn't matter what it is, it's just different degrees of bullshit. Oh, yeah. Religion is bullshit. Politics is bullshit. Salesmanship is bullshit. All of it's bullshit.
Oh, yeah.
And you can't argue with that. You can't.
No. It's all true.
Hey, I'm in communications. I took a class in advertising. It was
bullshit.
Yeah, it was basically bullshit 236. I mean,
my favorite part is what he said about customer service. The first man who got customer service walked away with a bleeding asshole. I mean, we all know that. That's basically what customer service is. Oh, he's about to service the customer.
And that's truthfully about it. I mean, you cannot sit there and expect that the world is basically a big, bad, fucking scary place. And there's nothing you can do about it. I'm wondering right now if my wife has actually gotten onto my computer and is now listening to the show.
Have you installed Winamp, or was it uninstalled?
Oh, yeah, it's all there. I'm betting she hasn't.
Probably not.
So I'm going to keep going in my usual non-whipped self.
Not going to change into whip mode.
Yeah, I don't have to go to whip mode. But, oh, hey, fuck. I mean, everyone, is Pixie Chick still there? Pixie Chick, women, like, they always whip their men.
She's still there.
There was a really brilliant guy I knew when I was in the Army, and he explained the whole whipped, non-whipped thing to me. And I'm going to pass this on to all our listeners. What it is that men have venom. In the jungle of Lipe, there is... Yeah, structural integrity, man. No whip. No, not at all.
No, not at all.
We're not going to go any further with that, but... In structural integrity, man, by the way, we got to get together. You're the fucking shit, and I haven't seen you in a Coon's age, so...
He should come to a show.
Anyway...
Never been to one.
What we've got to do is... Back to the description. Men have venom that they get in life. That's why you're all angry, and you're fucking wearing two shirts and say anarchy, and you're like, fuck you, I'm going to get around this shit. Duh! Right? That's what you do.
That's
and this venom keeps you hard and makes you able to deal with life. You know, the chick spurns you. She's like, I just want to be friends. And you're all like, fucking bitch, I don't need you anyway. That's why, right? Because you have that venom and you can throw burnt bottles and all the rest of it. But when you get a woman, what she does is she takes this venom away, which is good because if you keep the venom too long, you're the guy who's too old to be in the bar. You know that guy? The guy who's like 45, drives a Trans Am, listens to a lot of AC/DC. You know, hey, honey, holy fuck, you're balding, you know. So it's, you know, you're just a little too old to be in the bar. And this is why women are good, because they prevent you from becoming that poor, unfortunate son of a bitch.
Thanks.
No. Well, you don't actually hang in the bar, so you're safe. And we all love you. You know that. However, in doing that, they take away your venom. So you become venomless. And you're like, you know, listening to Barry Manilow. And you go to Lilith's Fair, you know, and you think you're cool.
Hey.
And you got...
I would never force my man to go to Lilith's Fair.
Yeah, no shit. I mean, if you want to keep him, I mean, all you get is a whiff of patchouli and some lesbian who'd take his fucking head off. That's about it. Wow! Holy fuck, what happened? A bunch of rabid lesbians called you a fucking repressor and killed your ass. And God would be up there, don't worry, they're not getting in here. I got that in the Bible. No lesbians allowed. Thanks for coming out. I miss the good old days. You know, when we used to be able to beat them with sticks and shit. That'd be awesome.
No thicker than your thumb. That was from the Catholic Church.
Yeah, no thicker than your thumb, man. Now they'll fucking get all righteous on your ass and they stop you. The world's kind of shit.
I'd like to thank you because I thought that perhaps only like Michael Janz was really this Coma Boy was actually this misogynist.
Oh, I'm totally not misogynist. I love my wife more than anything else, but a spade's a spade. I mean, let's just fucking call it what it is. I mean, I am so horribly whipped. I'm whipped in spades, man. I am so fucking whipped. I've got a pain tolerance that will bleed your fucking mind. I would go to Mutiny on the Bounty as a pleasure fucking cruise. I'm so whipped. Okay, that's how whipped my ass is. I have no skin on my back. I just have fucking tissue on bone structure. That's it. That's how fucking whipped I am. All she has to look at me and cry, and I fold. I mean, I'm fucking the weakest of weak.
Oh, Sean,
that's not true. I mean, my wife uses shit like gosh and golly. You know, she never actually swears. You know, it's annoying. I'm living with a fucking Disney character. Like, birds and shit are flying in the window and waking us up in the morning. Good morning. Good morning. You want to fuck off? You know, I'm sleeping here, all right? you know, every time we kiss, it's like magic. Yeah, it's like magic for me too, baby. But if I see one more rabbit come in here and sing a song to me, I'm going fucking mental. I thought it was the acid originally, you know. I thought it was just a bad trip. I'm going to pretend like nothing was happening because you didn't see it. Okay. But it's there. It's really fucking happening. Hello. There is no rainbow. Okay. I want it to stop. Fuck. You know? Try living in a Disney World, man. It's sad.
Time for a break.
Yes.
Right. This is something I downloaded off the internet. It's from a webpage that I'm going to put in the IRC. Blackout.com. It is just amazing. It's called Exotic Escorts Infomercial. And this is just awesome.
If you would like to email death threats or send mail bombs to anyone you're listening to tonight on What the Hell, email us at info@rantradio.com or send explosive charges to Box 256, Old Family BC, Canada, V0X1J0, or bother me on ICQ number 51558. Cash or fissionable is greatly appreciated. When are you going to die?
I will.
Are we back on the air?
Not quite.
Danger.
You're listening to the What the Hell Show and those sick individuals we call DJs on Ranch Radio.
How appropriate.
Yeah, we'd like to say sorry for the serious fucking chunk out.
It's not online.
Chop, chop, chop. Yep, it's going up in time. Choppy, choppy. Right. I don't know what's going on. I will have my computer fixed for next week.
Yeah. Are we actually on the air?
Oh, yeah. See that? I know, time's counting up.
I was hearing my mic seemed to be on, like, nothing, and now it doesn't seem to be.
I turned down the volume so that our neighbors don't hear us.
You're on. It's all good.
All right. Okay.
You are actually on. We can hear you. Oh, apparently we were having people go goodbye bye.
No, just one.
Just zombie. Which is weird because he's always like here till the end of fucking time. We can't get rid of the guy.
That's right.
So later, zombie. In any case, somebody said that I should rant about Seattle, and I suppose that's probably a pretty good point.
You know,
I
mean, enough about it.
WTO about Seattle, it. Yep. Sure. Okay. What the fuck? We went down to, I actually downloaded, and I'm probably going to send it over to Rant Radio. We're going to do something with it. But I got a chance to download. Some guy posted on one of the news groups a home video he shot of some cops fucking people over that never made it to the news.
Oh, yeah.
What a surprise.
Yeah, imagine that. Anyway, so I'm watching this. You know, I download it. And this, now, a lot of people, I mean, if you're acting all fucked up and you go to protest, okay, expect to get maced and fucking gassed and shit. I mean, it's like, you know, you come to play, you're going to play, right? That's all there is to it. But these guys were, like, trying to go home. Like, they were going to their house, and this guy and a girl were, like, walking, and they're like, we're trying to get home. They start yelling at the cops. The cop walks up to them, like, we're talking 80 feet back from the line, squirts her in the fucking face with capsium from, like, 4 feet away with this big, like, monster truck 2-liter canister, like, boof, have some of that, you know? Now, as funny as that would sound to do, like, oh, fuck you, bitch, you're going to yell at me? Gas. Okay, as funny as that all is, like, a lot of the shit that I talk about is basically entertainment, okay? We're not, you know, actually advocating killing people, okay? Well, not people, pedophiles, but not people. The true thing is, you look at this, and you see what the, Tiananmen Square, Seattle.
For purposes of legal defense, we're not advocating killing people.
Nope.
Just assume this is my legal disclaimer right now. Everything I say is bullshit. Okay? Now, there's my legal disclaimer. Now, shut the fuck up and listen. What it is that, I mean, these cops are sitting out there fucking gassing people. If some cop fucking gassed my wife and I'm just trying to go home and some fucking pig sits there and gasses her.
Just trying to get home.
Like, I'm just trying to get home. I want to go home. And then the cop gasses her. And obviously, you're going to start swearing at this point. Like, motherfucker, I don't think I'd say anything. I think I'd be like, going for a cash. Going for the weapons cache. Gonna kill me some pigs. Fucking die. You know, I mean, or would you rather be a merc? You know, really. What the hell? I mean, these guys are out there. They're fucking gassing people. They're trying to go home. What the fuck is that about? Oh, yeah, New World Order. Those Texans, they're way out of hand. You know, they're all fucking paranoid. Excuse me. I have to go home. I have to pack my van full of all the shit I can possibly cram in there, my computer, all the weapons, and go join me a Christian sect who's got a gun tower, okay? Because, holy fuck, was David Koresh wrong or not? Oh, he's paranoid. Excuse me. They're gassing people in Seattle who are trying to go home for no fucking reason. What the hell? In America, you know, home of the free, land of the brave, home of 1 in 10 people are in fucking jail. When 10% of your population is in jail,
something's wrong with your society.
There's something wrong here. There's something, and they're disproportionately black. I mean, what the hell? How does this fucking work? Like, okay, I don't know what the solution to all this is. I really don't. Maybe it's the fact that all the people in government are fucking Mormons. Maybe it's all, just this bullshit that's happening with the government right now is all fucked. I don't know what it is.
I'll tell you what it comes down to. And this was said by Smith. Al Smith was basically a congressman and the governor and mayor of New York for a number of years. So this is, we're talking back in the 20s and the 30s. He said the cure for the ills of democracy is more democracy.
What? How about you think about this, how about we just go right back to Shakespeare when he said there will be no peace until the last bishop is strangled with the entrails and the last politician. I think he had a lot more to
actually
go on that
I
one.
Think it was more along the lines of first we kill all the lawyers, but
they're good too, and fuck you and your crushed penis, have a nice day, thank you for calling, you know what the fuck, man.
Hey, Josh K. Would that be the Josh of yesteryear?
The Josh K? Who the hell? What are you talking
about? Meanwhile, the people on
DJ
the IRC
Josh.
Are talking about Pokemon.
Yeah. Oh, well.
Seattle.
Pokemon.
Let's talk about Pikachu instead.
So, yeah. DJ's... Okay.
Actually, I
just became mind-numbingly depressed. I'm going to bed now.
I have to take some small responsibility. I am partially
responsible. Did you see the movie?
No, I did not see the movie. Every year, I have taken whatever really disgusting, obnoxious object that has currently inundated our popular culture.
Evil cell phone making noise.
Yes, that's our cell phone.
Oh.
And basically taken whatever it is and burned it at a Halloween sacrifice.
That's better.
I did the Smurfs. They're
yep.
gone.
Yep.
I did Power Rangers twice,
Smurfs?
And unfortunately...
What the hell is wrong with Smurfs?
die. I did Power Rangers. Unfortunately, the power of our chants and our evil summoning spell was not that strong.
Uh-huh. They're still there.
And they're still there. I did Todd McFarlane. We did a tiny little Todd McFarlane thing uh-huh. because I think the comic book Spawn is evil. I did Barney.
Uh-huh.
Barney, I agree with.
And you didn't do Pokemon.
Didn't do Pokemon. I was thinking about a choice of either Teletubbies or Pokemon, and of course, it obviously was very quickly is became like Teletubbies. A third. It should be mentioned that a far behind third running was Furby, but we basically settled on
he's
Pokemon,
not too big.
And we never got around to doing it because I went. To Kurt and Tina's.
It should be pointed out that the Furby would have been really cool because we could have taught it to scream as the flames lit up before doing it.
That's right.
I should. I'm responsible. I like
yep,
to apologize
that's right.
to everyone.
And it just continues on
because
to torment us.
I
huh?
did not do my usual sacrifice. I did not.
That's probably why it was called the first movie.
I did not invoke the evil spirits.
As in, there's going to be a second.
Well, the thing is, the story, the thing in the movie, there's like, the movie is actually two short movies.
Yeah.
It's a short movie and another movie, but...
Yeah, it's like, well, the thing is, like, in Japan, like, I'm an anime freak. They have movies, they have OAVs, which are like videos, you know, the Japanese equivalent of the Bartok, the Magnificent type things.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, don't we all want to see that? And so there's, they call it the first movie in English.
Video.
Yeah. they're calling it the first movie there because I believe there was, like, that was a movie from, like, about a year ago, I think.
And they're already doing their next one?
In summer. They probably already had one, which was released just this past summer.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm guessing. It seems to be for whatever the popular anime is that year. There's invariably a movie for it in Japan.
Yeah. They're rabid. They'll latch on to everything, anything, really hard.
You know what this comes down to? This comes down to, and I normally do not pick on the United States, but I'm going to overchange. This comes down to the United States having this great idea of nuking a country, kicking their ass back to the fucking Stone Age, and then thinking they're responsible for basically building them back up.
Mm-hmm.
Let them wallow. If you look what you did. Okay, you had the right idea with Yugoslavia. You haven't really helped them build themselves back up. Or Iran. Iraq.
But
you
they loan them money.
You see, that's the problem. You basically get a good set of hate on. I mean, you bomb somebody back to the fucking Stone Age. Leave them there. Don't build them back up. Because if you do, 20 years from now, they're basically going to be buying your fucking property.
Uh-huh.
And you're going to have to deal with some really annoying fucking product from these people.
Who are we talking about?
Japan.
Pokemon.
So that other rant radio that I was talking about...
you're leaving us, Mr. Man?
Okay. That's excusable. That rant radio I talked about last week is gone.
It's gone?
Yes.
Yay!
The webpage is gone. File not found. And even if you go to their root,
somebody did something really horrible.
Oh, it's back up anyway. This was down, so maybe rant radio will come back up. But DJ Psycho alerted that to me. So good for that. They're not powerful enough. No.
DJ Psycho. Yes.
Yep.
So we don't have to worry about the other rant radio. The wrong for rant a while. Radio. The false rant radio.
You should still pursue registering your copyright of the name and the trademark and stuff.
I should.
It wouldn't also, another thing I would do is I would make sure that rant radio is registered at all the major search engines and stuff if that's possible. Because that way, you know, if somebody enters rant radio.
Yeah, it should come up, yeah.
We should do that because, I mean, we are the
one and only.
We've been around for 50 episodes.
That's right. Well, almost. 49. It's 49 this week.
What's your 1-year anniversary?
It is the week. It is the day after Christmas. It's Boxing Day.
Boxing Day.
Here in Canada and Britain.
Yeah, we're not going to do a
week. That's December 20th.
Long one, of course, for that.
But perhaps we might do something. Maybe we'll do a couple of.
We'll do it on probably the year anniversary, which is January 3rd.
January 3rd?
Something. Well, we won't even be here January 3rd.
Yes.
Some other time, we'll do a nice big long one.
You're going to do it instead?
Yeah, that was the station anniversary, is January
3rd. But January 3rd, we'll still be up in the bush.
That's right. We'll be recording the show remotely with the video camera and then coming back the next week and playing it.
So if you tune in after the 3rd, you'll get to hear what happened, various clips and cuts of what happened our camping trip to hell.
Yeah, or you won't be hearing it on January.
You'll find out who survived.
Yes, of course, actually Y2K happens, and then we're just basically staying up there.
That's right, we'll stay up there for a while, and you won't be hearing much of us. The power doesn't go out here.
There's a term for what we're about to do. It's called survivalists.
That's right. So I've got this list page up, and we did this a while ago. I'm sure there's some that we haven't done on here, so everyone can take a look at them in the studio here. Oh, my computer is dying. This has happened after I installed that real video server, and I think that's what the problem is.
Oh, that'd do it.
Installed
it
like 2 weeks ago.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm not running it, but something.
Real media.
Real media.
People who just have so much respect for the integrity of your computer system.
It's
Let's
so
snoop
poor,
around
though.
People's hard drives, you know, just for fun.
That's right. I think
if we don't tell them, they'll never find out, and we'll never get in trouble.
Yep. I don't think we've done classified ads. I'm not quite sure. Let's take a look at the classified ads.
Thump coming from outside?
It's anytime there's a pressure difference, the door opens and closes. I had to open a bit. Read this one.
This is new.
This is classified ads. The following are regrettably phrased classified ads that have been placed in newspapers across the nation. I'll do the first one. Man wanted to work in dynamite factory. Must be willing to travel. Next one.
Two female Boston Terrier puppies, 7 weeks old, perfect markings, 5551234. Leave mess.
Washing machine free to good home. Huh? Washing machine,
I guess.
Good, free to good home.
Just,
I guess.
Wants to make sure the washing machine goes to a good,
home.
Loving environment.
Just kind of silly.
I put that on anything that I get away free.
No matter what your top coat is made of, this miracle spray will make it really repellent.
Great Dames for sale.
Vacation special. Have your home exterminated. Yeah.
Get rid of aunts. Zap does the job in 24 hours.
Yep, instead of ants, it's A-U-N-T-S.
Gee, they made the funny.
Toaster, a gift that every member of the family appreciates, automatically burns toast. What were they supposed to say there? Instead of automatically burns toast.
Automatically cooks toast, makes toast.
Yeah.
Save regularly in our bank. You'll never re-get it.
That's a pretty good one. This is the model home for your future. It was panned by Better Homes and Gardens.
Panned. Panned. Panned means basically it was turned down instead of basically.
Oh.
They're thinking, I guess it means it was.
Planned.
No, not. I was. Not,
well,
maybe.
Maybe planned.
That or basically maybe showcased or something is what they were trying to think of. And they just didn't know the right word. This is old fast.
Keep it up. Come on. We can do it. Wanted part time married girls for soda fountain in sandwich shop. Part-time married.
Christmas tag sale. Handmade gifts for the hard-to-find person.
Wanted haircutter. Excellent growth potential.
Slap my knee. Mother's helper. Pleasant working conditions.
Peasant.
Peasant working conditions. Ah, I see.
Wanted, preparer of food. Must be dependable, like the food business, and be willing to get hands dirty.
Mmm. Mm. Well, you know, that's why. How do you think they get that home-cooked taste?
Mm-hmm, that's right. You're off?
We'll see you, the man.
See ya, Sean. We'll play your rants in effigy.
Oh, yes, my new
Got
rants.
Two rants, two new rants.
Well, I can stick around to see response to my two new rants if you play them out.
Couldn't we burn them in effigy? Couldn't we burn them in effigy?
We'll play one now. We have to space it out.
Oh, okay.
Which one do you want? We'll give you the
choice. What's our choices?
1 second. It is...
Somebody's breathing into the mic.
Yeah, it's Sean, I think.
Stop that.
Just a fad or more than you? I care more than you.
Just a fad.
Just a fad.
Okay.
All right, everybody, so have a good one, and I'll check you on the flip side.
Here is Just a Fad from Sean Kennedy, the man.
What the fuck ecos you ask for? Is your pal and mine, Sean Kennedy, on Rant Radio?
No. That's just
how it works.
Okay, so my wife works at Princess Auto. It's not a really great job, but it's pretty fucking good. And besides, what other place can you go where you get everything you need to buy a mecha? Sure, shitload better than Home Depot. But anyway, I'm in there. And this guy walks up to me and says, oh, what do you do? And I'm like, oh, yeah, I'm in telecommunications, yada, 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 yada. And he says, oh, yeah, you're into those computer things. And I'm like, yeah, yeah, I am. And he says, you know, those are a fad. And I said, pardon? A fad? What are you, fucking mental? I mean, what kind of people actually think? There are people still out there who really believe, I mean, deep down inside, these fucking guys actually think their computers are a fad. It's a fad, like a fucking hula hoop. It's gonna pass. How many hula hoops do you see attached to your car, asshole? I mean, the people who are out there, you run into these guys, they'll sit there and go, oh, yeah, well, you know,
Y2K is gonna destroy everything. Why won't you look stupid when your computer crashes?
Die. Like, fucking die. These people make me crazy. They're at the bottom of the fucking food chain, okay? I don't know how these people can walk and exist and why they even breathe my air. It pisses me off. Makes me a little nuts. Now, I understand that not everyone's at the same level, okay? I understand that some people, you know, they don't know what's going on with computers. I can accept that. I can accept, you know, that some people haven't really gotten on board yet. I don't even get mad with those senior citizens who sit in front of you at the bank lineup because they're trying to use the instant teller machine and they have no fucking clue what's going on and you want to hand them an Acrobus or something just so you can get, they can get the fuck out of your way so you can get your money and go buy your beer. You know what I'm saying? Those guys, I don't really have a problem with them. I want to help them, but I don't got a problem with them. But when some motherfucker comes up to me and says, hey, you know what? Computers are a fad. You just made yourself and my whole gene pool look absolutely retarded, okay? So if you're gonna make a comment about some shit like that being a fad, do me a favor, okay? Shut the fuck up. My name's Sean Kennedy, and I am the fucking man.
All right, that was Sean K, and Critical S wants me to say something. He says, hey, Sim, tell Sean K that I liked his book, and hey, it was really disturbing shit, but it was a good read.
Thanks, man. Nobody else thinks so. I mailed it to everyone, and they all told me... No. And nobody who matters, like the publishers.
The publicists.
Everybody else told me to basically suck ass.
Everyone's saying, yay, rants. This kicks ass. That's some good ranting. Right on. Are Sean K's rants available for download anywhere? All of them are available for downloading. At ftp.rantradio.com /SeanK.
Cool.
You can actually
you guys
just go
met
to FTP.
You'd be so disappointed.
ftp.rantradio.com.
How does he not breathe for 2 full minutes?
If you actually want to know how
shouting
that...
Shouting the whole time!
If you want to know how that's actually accomplished, I usually actually do the rants in one take, and what happens is afterwards I go and I just go through it with Cool Edit Pro, and I take out all my breathing. And that last one is actually very tight. That one I really went tight with.
Do you have any idea how many young girls you've just disappointed with saying that you actually need to breathe?
That's right.
Well, when I speak, yeah. But, yeah, I'm Sean Gay, the masturbational fantasy of 15-year-olds around the world. Yeah, I'll fucking bet. Yeah, anyway, I'm going home to my wife now, so...
Okay.
Anyway, hey, everybody be cool and fucking keep your head down.
And that was Sean K. leaving us.
Yay!
And it's time to phone the Movie Man.
Movie Man.
I have no. I said you're like I have no response to that. I just have no idea how to respond. I
shut you up.
What do you need?
I shut you up. I can't believe that.
It's not like I'm sitting here talking incessantly.
I know. No. I don't mean that. I realize that me and Darcy both have much larger mouths than, you know, the entire room put together. But but I just can't believe I left you wordless. I mean, it's just that's inconceivable to me.
Well, it's more the concern that I'd put my foot in my mouth.
Come on, Dak. You've actually made Enki blush once.
I know. That was the proudest moment of my life.
You did?
Yes, that was a
proud... You'll have to tell me how to do that.
How the hell did I do that again?
I don't know.
But I do remember actually Enki going, "That's sick, dude," and walking away. I felt so proud. It was one of those moments where, you know, you've actually gotten to where you wanted to be.
You've achieved.
Time for the movie, man.
Hello, Movie Man. How you doing?
Just fine. How are y'all?
Oh, pretty good.
Good, good.
So what have you got for us this week?
Okay, a movie review. I think chances are a couple of people have already seen it. The new James Bond movie.
Still haven't seen it.
I have not seen it, but I don't care. You can go ahead and...
All right, well, I'm just kind of... What was the little in the back there I heard?
That was Dak throwing up.
Okay, so I'm guessing he didn't like the movie.
Oh, not too much, I think.
Haven't liked a James Bond film since Sean Connery stopped playing the role.
That's why you keep seeing them, right?
No, actually, I don't go to see them, but I'm forced because my roommate has some sort of sexual fantasy involving James Bond. He wants to grow up to be him.
Well, I liked it.
Yeah?
I liked it, yeah. I think that next to Sean Connery, I think that Pierce Brosnan is the best Bond. Because Timothy Dalton, who was an absolute waste of time.
Uh-huh.
Dalton's a good actor, but he just doesn't have the savoir-faire to basically actually play Bond. I agree with you on that one.
And I think that, what's his name, the other guy?
Roger Moore.
I just couldn't buy him as Bond either. But apparently they are going to be replacing Pierce Brosnan for the next one.
I think his contract is up.
Who's going to play him?
They haven't decided yet, but... They are
going to
be getting somebody else. So it should be interesting.
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yes, I'm Bond. James Bond.
Interesting cast. I enjoyed the movie. I didn't have quite as many gadgets as I had hoped.
Lots of product placements?
Tons of product placement.
How else do they pay for the movie?
Absolutely.
The other thing that you're not mentioning, which was a real shame, was it was the final movie of Desmond Llewellyn, who's been known to play...
That's what I was about to mention.
Sorry.
The only person who has been in every single Bond movie.
Oh, really?
He plays Q.
Was he not there?
No, he was there.
Oh, it's his final, okay.
He plays Q, the gadget guy.
Right.
Who finally retires.
And
passes on the mantle to the new Q.
Who's played by...
R.
R?
Yeah.
Oh.
John Cleese is the new gadget guy.
John Cleese, yes, that's right.
That should be interesting.
Apparently he is amusing in the role, but...
It was a small part, but it is typical John Cleese. He's got the sarcasm down.
Oh, yeah.
So, it'll be interesting to see in the next movie how he does.
By himself.
Yes, without you.
Okay, and did you have a video review?
Did I have a video review? I actually have no video review.
Okay.
Review this week.
That's okay.
I have a couple for you for next week.
That's okay.
I do have a view for basically End of Days, which I did see.
Okay.
Does anyone want the film ruined?
No.
Okay.
Okay, plug your ears. Plug your ears and go la 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 la. If you don't want me to basically do this, the most wonderful part of the entire film is they actually kill Arnold Schwarzenegger at the end of the film.
Woohoo!
Yay!
Okay. Thank you. That's it.
That's all that you care about
yep,
in the
that,
movie.
That was it. Well, actually, it wasn't bad, though I thought what's-his-name was wasted in the role playing the devil. Gabriel Byrne. Yeah, he should have. They should have done a little bit more with him because I thought
used him okay.
I thought he was a little wasted.
Yeah,
but too
much walking around looking cool.
Yeah, that was basically the whole premise of the film for Lucifer.
Yeah.
Actually, you know what? If you check the credits and the end of the movie,
yeah,
he is not cast as the devil or Lucifer or Satan.
Oh, what did they bill him as?
He is billed as the man.
The man.
The man.
And that's all that he's billed as, because they never actually do say that he's the devil or just Satan or anything like that.
Some guy with a lot of good magical powers, able to bend time and space.
And do some really funky possession things. So that was.
But hey, I mean, who doesn't have that kind of power?
Well, yeah.
Oh God, if I did, oh, would there be problems in this world?
Or lack of them after
a
little bit.
Yes, yes, many things would be resolved.
Okay, well, thanks for the movie review.
No problem, gentlemen.
And we'll be talking with you next week.
See you, movie man.
Say what the hell.
What the hell.
All right. So, it's 10:10 right now. And what should we do now? Let's see.
Stamp your money?
We could do stamp your money.
Stamp your money.
I'd like to thank our... actually, I do have something to talk about. Our new mirror, which is...
It's a pretty
it's
mirror.
It's in New York, and it's actually our fastest mirror. It's three T3s and six T1s, which is amazing, mind-blowing speed.
If there are any listeners who are actually in New York, all I have
go
to
for
say,
that one.
All I have to say is... Hi, and this is coming from a fellow New Yorker who is wishing more and more every day that he never left that city.
And the mirror name is crackhouse.rantradio.com:8000. So if you're having trouble and you live in the New York or close to that area, it's really, really fast.
Or it's probably just because we're choppy.
It could be because we're choppy tonight. I'd like to thank Head Peon for that. And I think
thank
he
you,
is
Head
in
Peon.
The... I think he's in the IRC right now under the name NextNet. Oh, it's not New York. It's in New Jersey.
Oh, damn. Never mind.
Take all that back, huh?
Just retract the statement.
Well, like, as I've said before, basically New Jersey, which is not a bad town.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it's, you know, some of the cities. Jersey basically always reminds me of, as I use it to describe anyone who lives out here, it's kind of like Surrey, only it smells worse. And if you want to know what
it's like,
Surrey
except
is like,
smells like Langley.
Yeah, exactly. That's about it.
And I'd like to thank Isaac509 at www.sonic.net for another mirror. And Red5 for no particular reason.
Hi, Red5.
Hi, Red5. I don't think he's listening tonight. He is there. Thank you, Red5. That's about it. I think I've got some things to say down here. Black Wolf, was that in reference to the radio station, that link you sent me? Does it mean
actually,
anything?
I was trying to find more information in it.
What's
it
about?
It was mainly because of
just closer.
Part of the Privacy Act and all that. There should be more information in there, but it was about such things as, a bank found out a couple of people were cancer patients, so they canceled their loans.
Okay.
And just stuff like that where it's...
They shouldn't know about this kind of thing.
Yeah, they're finding out personal information about these people and canceling things like life insurance and
right.
just like one person. Some girl was involved in getting into some money or something. Next thing you know, she gets a Visa card pre-applied, pre-approved.
Yep.
And just things like that, where they're finding out information and they're using it just completely wrong here.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the basic thing is that, I mean, I'm taking a class. One of the classes I'm taking is called Information Rights in the Information Age.
Oh, perfect.
And one of the first things we learn in that class is that private companies basically can do anything they want with any personal information that they get about you. Anything. Nothing is illegal.
There is there is no laws against anyone doing anything as a company.
Once they find out, it's okay.
The government in Canada here is passing this bill. It was C-54. It's now C-6.
Yeah.
It got the quickie passage through the House of Commons because they'd already done all the debating the last round of chit chat, which they'd done. And
speaking to the mic.
This is a basically the first real national privacy bill that doesn't just pertain to sort of government documents, stuff that like companies would have to do. And it's mainly sort of designed for e-commerce, but it's the thing is, like, the who do you think is lobbying against it? The insurance industry, you know, the medical industry, because, you know, exactly for that kind of reason is that they want to, you know,
they want to know if you smoke or have AIDS before they give you insurance.
Yeah, basically the banks and the banks and the doctors want to be able to trade information about you.
When my mom passed,
for a good price.
My mom passed away, like he was saying about the credit cards. When my mom passed away, I got the house. After about a year, I discovered that there was just no way I could afford to actually pay all the mortgage and all the things.
Right.
So I sold it off.
Well, how old were you back then?
I was 26, 27.
Yeah.
I just couldn't afford it.
Yeah.
I basically sold it, and within a month, I got two credit cards. Pre-approved.
I'm wondering how long it would take them to find out about me, because, like, I've been pretty fastidious. My parents sort of pointed out to me that, you know, every time you enter a little contest, you're going into a database.
Oh,
yeah. They pointed this out to me when I was really young.
They sell those for good money.
And so I'm very careful. You know, I haven't got my information, like, automatically entered into Netscape so people can find out who my what my name is just when I bump into their webpage, stuff like that. But, you know, I'm finding myself wondering, like, as it stands, I'm still pretty broke, but once I get a job, how long is it going to be before I start getting, you know, oh, that's funny, I got a credit card in the mail.
Oh, yeah. I got something for Rant Radio the other day. My first piece of mail for Rant Radio.
Really? Like,
how did they get it?
Was it
the
like
only
a
thing
bank?
I've ever put.
Like a business mail?
No,
kind of
some computer thing. They obviously gleaned it from my address from when I registered rantradio.com.
Oh, so they're getting it from like Network Solutions. Oh,
yep.
Good.
Which is publicly available. Which is publicly available. Right, they can just type it in. And
one thing that was like one of the things that was happening was that SFU, my university, was selling off a couple years ago. Was apparently selling off the alumni list. The thing is, the university is considered a public institution, so it's bound by the same rules as in BC as the government's put under, and the government can't sell off information about you to people who want to sell credit cards and house insurance and shit. So, so they got in trouble.
Another good thing to remember is anytime you say yes to a donation over the phone, your name is on a list, and that list is sold around to different donors.
Not only that,
is that
there's
called the sucker list, perhaps?
There's another thing that's going on. It's basically I gave donations to Greenpeace. This is a number of years ago, back before they split into the World Wildlife Fund and a number of different other than the Sea Shepherd Society. This is going way back. And I remember after I had done the donation, about 6 months later, we got a letter in the mail from them. They had found out that everyone who was on their donation list was given a record with the FBI as being a member of a terrorist organization.
So you're a member now of a terrorist organization?
Oh, I've got something.
Right.
Was I telling you about this? Somebody was telling me that one of the people at SFU, one of the Purgies, was involved in the anti-racist action, some kind of group.
Yep.
And this, of course, this group has its more radical members and its less radical members, but it's a larger group which spans, you know, I think it's a nationwide organization at the very least. And she thinks her phone was being tapped by CSIS.
Hmm.
CSIS being the Canadian equivalent of, I believe, the FBI.
The FBI, yes.
Yeah.
And she was, you know, like weird clicks on the phone and things like that.
You should get a voltage meter, and you can actually tell when they
see it drop.
Click into it, you'll notice a voltage drop.
Ah, that's how you do it.
I know anything about this stuff.
Back in the days when I used to role play for many, many hours back in Cloverdale, and we used to have all our friends come over there, one of our neighbors came up to my mom, this is back when she was still alive, and said, I think some of your son's friends are using drugs. Well, why? Well, they've come across to the apartment across the street, and the police have rented an apartment to basically photograph all the comings and goings. Now, we did no drugs.
You have people coming in and out of the house all the time.
Yes. So
strange late hours.
Strange late
evening.
Hours. That's so right. The police basically, as soon as my mom, of course, passed this on to me, we did the only thing we could. We sent them pizza. We waved.
That's awesome.
We would walk out the door talking about, hi, I'm going to get the Coke. Then we'd come back with 8 or 9 bottles of, 2 liters of Coca-Cola. But we did this until finally they basically just gave us the finger and closed up shop. But they were watching us for 2 weeks.
Wow.
Was this back? Was this back in the day when everybody was getting really paranoid about D&D as well?
No. This had nothing to do with it. They just thought they had a bunch of young guys who were driving all sorts of really fast cars. Because my brother, Chris King, Tom Kelson, a few others were basically car monkeys, and they used to basically literally throw their engines to the point where the speed of the laws of physics were bent around the vehicles.
Because you just look so much like a drug dealer, Dan.
Yeah, I do.
Oh, yeah.
You're
badass.
So we've got another Sean K. rant that I'm going to play now, and it's called More Than You on Rant Radio.
What fuck egos you ask for? Is your pal and mine, Sean Kennedy, on Rant Radio.
That's just how it works.
You know what makes me crazy? I'll tell you what makes me crazy. It's the fact that a lot of people just don't give a shit about trying to change things in the world today. Like, they just sort of accept shit as it's happening, Somebody fucks you around and, like, some cop gives you a ticket and you don't want to fight it because I'm just one person. What can I do? I'm one person. I can't fight anything. Hey, David Koresh was one guy, okay? Hitler was one guy. They're all one person. Jesus was one guy. Well, one guy type figure. But the point of the matter is that he was one person and he did a whole lot of shit. Nobody does as any kind of inclination to go and try anything because we're all lazy motherfuckers. Nobody wants to go out and try anything because they're all too lazy. We've been in our nice little glass cages and we've been pressing little button and getting our little cheese grub wherever the fuck else they want to feed us, and we never try to make a difference. So all those vegetarians and all those people out there who actually are trying to make a difference, and people call them freaks and they say, oh, you're just going against the flow, you're trying to be different, you got your pirate internet radio stations and you think you're going to make a difference. Hey, we're doing a lot more than you are, so shut the fuck up. My name's Sean Kennedy and I am the fucking man.
Short nice, and to nice, the point.
Short to the point, yes.
That's right. That was
that
Sean Kay with more words of wisdom. Yeah, almost, huh? I send spam out every week.
You bastards.
To people who want it, they get
it's
on my
spam.
List. It's not spam.
Spam
it's
is unsolicited email. This is solicited email.
Solicited ICQ messages.
This isn't spam. It's more like...
friendly spam.
It's more like prim.
Because they don't ask
it's
for it
more like
time,
Libby's potted meat food product.
That's
no,
right.
That's worse than spam.
So I send it out, and it's almost the same every time. And it's... what I send out, it says, it's Sunday night, 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, live from Rant Radio. It's time for What the Hell Show with Samarin and Private Drexel. Open Winamp, press control, and type T3 Sonic, blah, 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 and then I say some witty comment or unwitty comment after that. But somebody replied back. It was microdot-@micropoo.com.au. And he says, it's Sunday night at 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, and I don't care about www.rantradio.com. It's time for the What I Don't Care show. Samarin and Private Drexel has continued without me. I don't mean to be negative, but I'm just bored, and this is the most common message I get. It's a lifeless one without humor or humanity. Open Winamp and press Control L, and then suck my knob. Now with less snorkels, Drex forgot his brain. I edited that for so you could understand it.
Now with less snorkels?
Now with less snorkels.
What are snorkels?
I know what a snork is, but I don't know what a snorkel is.
Okay, yeah,
snorks
that's what they are.
Snorks were those little 1980s cartoon guys. It was
with
like
a thing
like
out
a
of their head.
Little round heads with like a little sort of tube, a bent tube. It looked like one of those little bendy straws.
It's the Smurfs.
Underwater Smurfs.
Yeah. The thing that
Smurfs.
Went up against the Smurfs for ratings, I guess.
Yes,
it was. I apparently miss this. We didn't have this in the States, and all I have to say is thank Christ.
This was back before we had Canadian cartoon channels. So this was back. This was back.
I never actually saw them. I knew of
this.
Them.
Was probably around the same era that we had the Pac-Man comic. TV, like the Pac-Man cartoon on TV. Well,
there was a lot of really bad cartoons around that era.
Somebody had, one of the magazine I saw had a list of the 10 worst cartoons. Most of them were from the 80s. The Gary Coleman Show, I remember that one. The Punky Brewster
Never
Show.
Heard of the Gary Coleman Show.
They somehow managed to miss the New Kids on the Block cartoon.
Oh man.
I'm thinking that should have been up near the top five worst. Okay?
Oh yeah,
come
right
on.
Up there.
Never saw it.
Be grateful. Be grateful.
I think I switched the channel.
The most entertaining character was the dog.
Oh, there's a lot of bad cartoons.
They just had these pasted-on smiles. Wow, we're in big trouble now.
A snorkel is the tube that you breathe through when you go shallow water diving.
No, but it's spelled differently. They have a
yeah,
spelled
L-E.
Snorkel, L-E.
Yeah.
So presumably he means something else.
A spell checker, maybe? It's
yeah, he wasn't too intelligent. Or the MC Hammer cartoon show.
Oh, yep. Oh, nice.
I missed this one also.
NextNet and Pixie Chick put that on the screen at the same time.
I think that was. I think that one was up against. I think that one was up against the New Kids on the Block show. What else was there? But there was like the Gary Coleman show. I remember this from when I was a very young child.
Was it a cartoon?
It was a cartoon.
Okay. Did he do the voice?
The idea was that Gary. I wouldn't know.
Probably.
I was too
Hi,
young to know.
This is Gary Coleman.
Gary Coleman. Was playing an angel who was earning his wings.
Really?
He was earning his wings, and he could do stuff like he could take his halo and like throw it at bad guys.
What?
He was stuck in this sort of, you know, Sesame Street style urban setting, and he had this sort of older sort of guardian angel who, if I recall correctly, like this is the part which I'm sort of fuzzy on. She was this like redhead with like, you know, curly frizzy hair and glasses, and she was like his sort of big sister figure who was telling him all the things he had to do to get his wings. And of course,
I think that
show
would be hilarious to watch.
You came close, but you're just gonna have to try again next Saturday.
Well, this is actually no. Think about it, everyone. You're missing the point. She pointed out something, and we're all missing it.
What
this implies that Gary Coleman is dead.
Yes, you're right.
This is a good thing. I mean, I would have tuned in just to see Gary Coleman dead.
Big dead.
It was a Punky Brewster show, and she had some kind of little magical Furby-like creature.
You always have to have a magical creature when you're
taken from a TV show to a cartoon. What was the name
of
the actress that played Punky Brewster? Moon Unit Zappers.
Soleil Moon Frye. She was dating Marky Mark for a while.
Wow. Okay, now, like, I remember I basically had seen this chick do the show as I, like, quickly channel surfed pastor.
Yes.
I never watched an episode. And then I remember one day I was like looking at her on Entertainment Tonight because she was going to have a breast reduction.
Yeah.
Sweet Jesus, what the hell happened to this kid? It was like
yep. That's why she went off the show.
Yeah, no kidding.
She wasn't cute anymore.
No, she was vivacious. It was
Now we're going to play the Gary Coleman promo because we're talking about Gary Coleman.
I'm sorry.
Hi, this is Gary Coleman, and I just wanted to remind you to listen to Rant Radio.
Should I apologize now for just bringing up the topic? There were other cartoons on the list. I can't remember what they were, but those are the ones that I recalled from like my own personal childhood.
There were so many bad shows when we were growing up, but you kids were at least a little bit luckier than the fact that you didn't have to deal with some of the truly ugly animation. I mean, I agree. Some of the stuff you guys did with the last 10 years was ugly, but the stuff that me and Projectile Vomit Man sitting across the table from me had to grow up with I can't describe it. It was monstrously ugly. It was okay. What was it?
And then there's the same five episodes of Scooby-Doo over and over again.
Yes,
right? That's right. We were old enough to have witnessed the birth of Scooby-Doo.
Yes, we are old enough to remember the birth of Scooby-Doo.
Wow.
I never understood that even when I was a little kid I never really got into the show.
I never understood why that Marcy girl was always wearing that ugly ass orange turtleneck. Like, rain or shine, hot or cold, she was always wearing
turtleneck
the same
sweater. Ugly-ass
clothing. I'm just like, borrow the purple girl's clothes. Okay? She always looks hot.
Yep, short skirt.
What about the outfit Freddie always wore that hadn't been cool since about 1967?
The man was wearing an ascot. Nobody, I mean, most of you kids don't even know what the fucking ascot is.
Is it that thing that
My boyfriend identified him as gay.
Yes.
My boyfriend has this whole theory that they're just like these misfits. Like, okay, you've got the talking dogs. Yeah, you've got like, you know, Shaggy's obviously taking copious amounts of drugs, and he's just a little too emotionally
Casey
involved
Kasem.
With his dog, you know. And you know, then you've got Freddy, who's, you know, gay as the day is long, and then you've got
never hit on the girls.
Thelma.
And then you've got those two girls. You know, yeah. The I believe that's called the love.
Shaggy's got intestinal worms.
And it's just like, you notice how they're always going from town to town, right?
Vagrants.
They never stay in one town because, because you know, the people in the city, they're like, yay, they solved a crime. Let's keep them here. And then they find out about them. And they chase them
out. There's some sort of like the twisted, perverted Manson family that's driving around in their van.
That's right. Just weird. I watch it. I flick it just to hear Casey Kasem's voice do Shaggy. It's just, it's so funny. I just can't believe it.
It's like the theory of Murder, She Wrote, you know, Jessica Fletcher being a serial killer.
Right.
Wandering around the country framing people for murders that she actually committed.
She's just really good at making the
murders
look.
Supposedly now, like Cartoon Network is trying to revive Scooby-Doo, right? So, you know, trying more new excuses to air the same 5 episodes over and over. So they're working on
a
video. There's apparently a video out there, and they've like slightly updated the outfits. Like I think Freddy lost the scarf.
He lost the ascot.
I'm not sure. I'm gonna have to you know see if I can find this online. But I think I vaguely remember seeing the box for this video, and they slightly.
The mystery machine.
Critical S. No, Chugs Drano. God thought. The burning.
The Wayback Machine was cool. The burning.
The Wayback Machine. That was Rocky and Bullwinkle.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Rocky, watch me pull a rabbit out of my ass.
But that trick never works.
Simon and Mr. Peabody. Simon and Mr. Peabody. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you think it's time for Gross Hospital Stories
10:30? I could tell something for Gross Hospital.
We've held these people captive long enough. Because we know that's what they come here for, to listen to. Yeah, he was supposed to do
one. Yeah, he was going to do a Gross Hospital story, but he just chickened out, so I'm going to have to tell.
He's whipped, so he has to go home, you know.
I mean, that's fun
he
if you
self-admitted.
Do it, right?
You got the rainbow script going.
Yeah, that's really pretty. When you first started.
Oh, a long time ago. I haven't been in IRC for a long, long time.
I honestly don't have IRC so installed chunky. on my machine, because it's like Derek once back when he was still at our house, he had, you know, he installed IRC and he said, "Hey, look, Eric, I've got an IRC program." I said, "That's kind of like saying, hey, look, I have a little bit of crack." I was serious. You know, this is at the time I'd heard these people telling stories about, you know,
so
grad
true.
Students that had lost, like, entire semesters because they were just, they sat and vegetated in the lab.
I lost a year of my life to the IRC. I sat, the only things I did, I would wake up, usually about 11 o'clock, and about 11 a.m., I would go sit down to the computer, play for, maybe an hour. Of course, playing was talking on the IRC.
Mm-hmm.
Then I would go have something to eat, take a shower.
You took a shower? You had more hygiene than most IRC users.
Yeah, I think so.
So I'd go sit down and do more computer. Run upstairs, grab some food, bring it down, and IRC while I ate.
Uh-huh.
This would continue till approximately 7 a.m. Repeat until very well stirred.
Uh-huh.
Oh yeah.
For a year.
Wow.
Did you you like fail?
This is
school
when you're out of high school.
No, this was just after out, and I was
doing nothing.
Kind of between
working.
Jobs type thing. I was
living in your parents' house.
Oh yeah, of course.
Oh, of course, yes.
Yep.
But I was.
How I wasted my summer vacation.
I was delivering for KFC, and
you
so
worked.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry, you are not a true user of the IRC then.
Yeah, but
you could drive.
You took time off.
You could drive.
Yeah.
That's
you actually knew what the world looked at like outside of your parents' basement?
That's why I went to the IRC.
Uh-huh.
I could not handle the world. I still have problems with the world.
This.
I still have this nasty urge when
Josh,
I see people. I
Josh
don't think
K,
they should breathe.
I intend to spend the rest of my 17th year on IRC.
Josh, get laid. Go out, get laid. Find
something.
He has
aspirations, though.
Hey, as long as you just plan to do that year, as long as you wake up sometime
do
and go,
one
holy
year.
Shit,
where is
I
it
just
gone?
Wasted a lot of time.
Where is it gone?
You're okay.
You're doing the IRC thing right now, but this is better. This is an okay thing. You only come up once a week and chat with people, and you can interact. So,
okay.
In a real-life way, we're real people. You can hear us.
To talk. You can put That's in right. so much more data when you talk.
Okay, let's get on to Gross Hospital.
Gross Hospital story. So here's the intro.
Eventually.
Oh, Did I actually click on it? There we go.
And now, once again, it's time
for Gross Hospital Stories.
Hi, boys and girls. Time for your Uncle Dak to tell you another disgusting story.
Yay!
Once upon a time, your Uncle Dak spent 5 years.
5 years.
That's
a long time, Dak.
5 years working at a hospital.
You must have amassed a lot of stories.
I got a few of them.
He was training tonight for one, though.
Yeah, actually, I had not bothered to think of something, so I actually slipped into the...
Made something up.
No, I did not. I slipped into the not-so-gross and went more into the violent and looked for the grossest violent story that I had. So this is gross, violent hospital stories.
Before you do that, tell them the security guard joke.
Oh, yes. This joke was told to me by a cop one evening. How many security guards does it take to throw a punk down a flight of stairs?
How many security guards does it take to throw a punk down a flight of stairs?
None. He tripped. like I said, that was told to me by a police officer.
Whoa.
Well, this one evening, unbeknownst to me, as I wandered off to go get a bite to eat for a change. Yeah, for a change. Fuck off. I basically came back upstairs, and I did not know at the time that the police had brought in a suspect who had gotten a little bruised by the officers as they brought him in.
A little resistant, wasn't he?
Yes. So they basically cracked his nose, and he was bleeding from his nose. So they brought him in to get him checked out, leaving him handcuffed to the bed. Now, like I said, I'm downstairs just getting a bite to eat. Come back up. Now, from what I was told, when the officer unhooked him from the bed to put the handcuffs back on both of his wrists, he turned around and punched the cop in the nose. Brian remembers this story from his laughter, I take it.
No. We're all friends here, even that retard lieutenant.
Zombie, yes. Okay.
We're all friends here.
Okay, so the guy punched the cop in the nose, dropped the cop, and went running out trying to think of the name of the room now, the fast track room, which is where they do all the basic work and the little minor surgery you get in the emergency room, the trauma rooms. Went running out of fast track to go towards the front door. Now, one of the nurses in the nurse's station saw me coming up, and she just screamed, "Desmond, get over here fast!" And so I just start running as fast as I can, thinking this one of the nurses, one of my friends, is being hurt.
Uh-huh.
I ran full tilt into this guy who's about Brian's size. Projectile Vomit Man is 5'6", about 160 pounds, soaking wet with a wet radiator on his back. 150 pounds, okay. That's about the same size as this guy.
I weigh 140.
I weigh 265.
Boom.
I saw the guy at the last second, and to put it mildly, I put my belly out. So essentially, I body slammed this guy. He goes flying back about 4 feet, rolls on the floor, begins grabbing his chest and making a funny noise. They pick him up, and they take the shirt off. They notice that one side of his chest looks funny.
Oh!
I didn't break his ribs. I detached his sternum.
Oh.
That's where your ribs connect to the central breastbone.
Look, Ma, no hands.
Oh. I detached his sternum from his chest, from his ribs.
Good thing he's in a hospital.
Yes. He's making little grunting noises. I had the wind knocked out of me. That's all.
Utterly destroyed his chest.
They pick him up. They wheel him into basically x-ray. The doctor can't believe what happened. The cop is standing there screaming at the top of his lungs to the guy that he's lucky I hit him. Because if he had got his hands on him, he really would have fucked him up.
Whoa.
They have about 4 other police officers show up. I have to fill out 15 fucking pages of reports, 3 copies for everybody.
I ran into him.
Yes, that's basically what I had to say on
there's 15, not much to it.
15 separate pages of this, the same thing. Do you think they'll let me photocopy any of this or basically use like, no, I have to write it out 15 times because the hospital gets 3 copies, the police get 3 copies, I have to keep 3 copies, my company gets 3 copies, and they want 3 more copies for the administration of the hospital.
Wow. Well, that was pretty gross.
So you were physically unhurt, except for a vicious case of writer's cramp.
Yes.
That was the most hurting
actually,
part of it.
Actually, I'll be honest. I got the wind knocked out of me. I kind of stumbled back a couple things, and it took me at least 2 seconds to catch my breath. It took much longer for him.
Well, yes, seeing as part of the musculature that allows him to inhale is
no longer there.
Hey, look, my lungs have a smaller area to be in. Oh, wait, that's inefficient, isn't it?
Yeah.
Supposedly.
Good night, Anki.
Supposedly, there's a gross.
That he's really been here very much tonight.
No.
Anyways,
oh, he's here for the first half hour, I guess.
Yeah.
He's never usually here for the show.
Yeah, he was here. He was here sucking down a bowl of Campbell's soup.
Salt.
His usual pithy comments.
Yeah.
He did.
We are slowly but surely going to archive all the shows and gross hospital stories. I don't know where the gross hospital story is right now. It's supposed to be on the computer. It's somewhere. So if you go to ftp.rantradio.com, eventually you will find all these amazing stories online. There's a zoom little toggle left, right in the back of the camera, top of it.
Press the W.
It goes back and forth a little
Dax
twiddly knob.
Dax trying to figure out the camera. Here we go. Okay.
Yay! That should be good.
Josh K., I think he was all excited about us saying his name.
Josh K.
Yay.
Hey, how about Josh K.?
They've mentioned my name 3 times. See, we're big radio celebrities, so yes, it's a big event.
We're big shots.
Yep.
I drive up here in my limo.
That's more than they
you
mentioned
drive
my
the
name.
Limo? Oh, I get my limo driven. I sit in the back and
dragged in the street. I basically apparently didn't get as good an agent as you guys.
Oh, look at that. DJ Psycho sets mode, minus brain for Josh K. Takes away his brain. Oh yeah, I remember. We do have something to do. We have movie quotes.
Movie quotes.
Yes, I did it this week.
Oh yeah, that has been a while.
Yep, well, 1 or 2 shows. So, we all know how this is played for all you new people, and there are a few new people this week.
Hi, new people.
And it's Josh K. and Pixie Chick. And, and some people haven't listened in a while. So how we play this game is we've got some movie quotes that I have gleaned off the internet. And I'm going to turn down the sound in the studio here.
The Rant Radio Studio.
Big Rant Radio Studio in luxurious Langley.
Langley, B.C.
B.C., Canada. And you can tell by our Canadian accents, A.
A.
Our British Columbian accents.
What's it, a boot?
It's a boot, Yeah, I've never heard anyone say a boot.
It's vaguely like that on the East Coast.
I'd put a boot on my foot.
Yeah. Vaguely. It's not that strong a boot.
Langley, there is a boot on my foot.
Langley, we're so big we've actually gotten Canada's first freestanding Walmart.
Are you kidding me?
No, apparently the other Walmarts have basically been like, you know, like they're in malls, and they were old Woolco stores. Woolco being
does ours have a McDonald's?
By Walmart.
Yes,
but
it does.
The Langley one is the first freestanding, you know,
there's a McDonald's just down the street from it.
Yes, there is. There's
how many McDonald's in Langley now?
There's 8.
Think of it this way.
I think there's actually 5.
Think of it this way. There's like like the Tim Hortons, which is right in front of the Staples. Then there's the Tim Hortons, which is like just down the bypass, which is like, you know, like maybe 60 seconds drive away from it.
Yeah.
Well, think of A&W.
That's crazy.
A&W, yeah.
Used to have 2 in the mall, 1 in the mall parking lot.
Yeah.
And where's the nearest one after? Oh, then there's the drive-in.
Hey, for what? Had 3 in the mall. Because there was the one in the old part. No, that's right. That's true. But it's like.
I mean, in Langley itself, there's probably about 1, 2, 3, 4. I think at one point there was about 6 or 7 A&Ws. Just in the main part
now,
of Langley.
The drive-in one, we have Canada's last drive-in A&W. I have to say, that is cool.
That is pretty
cool.
Yes,
the last one.
The last drive-in period now.
There must be some in the States.
No, there are some drive-ins, but it is Canada's drive-in A&W is right here in Langley.
Wow. They use it for like the retro car shows and stuff.
What really amazes me is the number of restaurants in this suck-ass little town
I live in. It is amazing.
Not that anybody, good.
Does anybody in this town actually eat at home?
They're too busy running their kids to soccer practice in their SUVs to cook.
That's right.
I could not believe this town basically went two ways, and she's right. Half of it went to fucking Yuppieville, and the other half went to the white dreg trash of society.
Uh-huh.
And
trash, like, but we can't afford trailers.
Oh, yeah, there was, like, I don't know, like, there's this one Japanese restaurant I really like to go to.
Okinawa right Garden?
This is Miraku, where they have,
Miraku.
Yeah. And they have the considerable sized portions for Japanese restaurant. But they have, like, the in front of their restaurant, it's like in a little small strip mall. It's like Skater City because it's curb heaven in front of it. And they're always trying to chase off these skaters because they're zipping by right in front of the door. And eventually somebody's going to get slammed by that door, right?
Hopefully me. Blade out.
Anyways. So, and guess what moved in next to them? A skateboard shop. Snowboard shop. And
Perfect, huh?
The amusing part was that I was there, getting some dry cleaning, and it wasn't kids coming up in skateboards. Mm-hmm. It was kids being driven to the store by their daddies in big, stinking SUVs.
Wow. They won't even skate there anymore, huh?
No. Only posers actually go under their own power.
Well, just look at the schools now. I mean, when you look at it... At a high school, and like most of the kids, some of them had their own vehicles, but there were so many of them that didn't have their own vehicle, nobody walks. There's no kids that walk to school anymore. There's like maybe a dozen, maybe two dozen.
The ones that live right across the street.
Yeah, but if they live more than a block away, they're either driven by their parents, like they don't even ride a bike.
No.
You know why that is? Is like there's actually been like news stories about this. It's like a vicious circle because there's so many bloody cars around the schools dropping kids off that you don't want your kid walking
too
through
hazardous
that.
because it's a threat.
Parents driving big ass cars full of screaming kids, they drive like idiots. It's a fact of like the people that are
distracted.
Parents know this especially. They don't want their kids walking through that parking lot on their
or riding
own.
Their
Fuck
bike.
No,
that's nope. Something that really bugs me is. When you see people flip out, say, "Oh my God, people shouldn't be driving crazy in school zones." Look at yourselves.
Yeah.
It's the people dropping the kids off. Parents that are being stupid. Like they'll pull out and they'll cut you off and burn out of the parking lot, and you just look at them and go, "Okay, I'm in the sports car doing 30 kilometers an hour. You're in the minivan doing 70.
Yeah,
who can
you're
stop
safer.
Faster?
Yeah,
there's." People who like pull out of school parking lots with like a busload full of small screaming children without actually looking into the road to see if there's anybody on the road yet because damn it, they're in a hurry.
That's right, damn it.
I saw that happen. I mean, I've seen that happen many times. I remember actually being in a carpool going through the local elementary school zone and like seeing somebody pull out and like in front of us, we actually had to like slam on the brakes screeching. We were heading right for like a little 6-year-old the window going, mommy.
Pressed up against the window. Okay, let's get to the movie quotes. So first one to type it in wins the prize.
I don't have a keyboard.
Oh, well, you get to do it in here after. So here's the three movie quotes for this evening.
If you would like to email death threats or send mail bombs to anyone you're listening,
he's on life support. Doctors say he's got a 50-50 chance of living. Though there's only a 10% chance of that.
Oh, you men are all alike. 7 or 8 quick ones and you're off with a boy.
The boast and brag.
You better keep your mouth shut.
Well, why is that all
I think
hell?
I love him.
I guess they're right. Senior citizens, although slow and dangerous behind the wheel, can still serve a purpose.
A word out of the quote, so it won't help you. Okay, we're back, and now we're going to play it for the studio audience here.
For our Rant Radio DJs.
Oh, nice clean changeover,
DJ,
Sim.
I'm not a DJ.
Thanks. Yeah, I'm professional. I get paid for this. Yeah, right. If I got paid, I'd do it much, much better.
He's on life support. Doctors say he's got a 50-50 chance of living, though there's only a 10% chance of that.
Oh, you men are all alike. 7 or 8 quick ones, and you're off with the boys to boast and brag. You better keep your mouth shut. Oh, I think I love him.
I guess they're right. Senior citizens, although slow and dangerous behind the wheel, can still serve a purpose.
There are the three.
I know. I don't know which one it's from, but I do know the first one, and yeah. I definitely know the second one.
Okay. Anybody else?
The last one.
Okay.
I have a suspicion about the first one, but that's about it.
Okay.
Okay. The first one is from one of the Naked Gun movies.
Yeah.
I don't know which one. The second one is from.
Right there.
The second one is from Mel Brooks's. What was the Western that he did?
Blazing Saddles.
It was from Blazing. That's not what. That wasn't. That was Young
Frankenstein. All right.
Oh, that would explain why I don't.
But
know.
It is. Projectile Vomit Man gets the second one. What's the name of the actress? That was Madeline Kahn.
Okay. Died this week.
Did Madeline Kahn passed away? Yes. Holy shit!
I think it was ovarian cancer. Yeah, it was on Slashdot.
That is a shame because she was a comic genius.
Timely quote.
Timely, very timely.
And the final
that was
one,
intentional, right, Sim?
No, it was totally unintentional.
Totally.
I didn't get
what
that.
Was the last quote?
Not a fucking clue.
Seniors about being slow.
Wasn't that Cable Guy?
Great person.
It was
movie.
Jim Carrey. I thought it was Jim
Carrey.
Which one was that?
It wasn't Ace Ventura.
Nope.
Dumb and Dumber?
Yes. Dumb and Dumber.
I was just guessing Jim Carrey movie.
So you don't really get that one. I'll hand it to you anyway. So Dak wins this week with Projectile Vomit Man as runner-up.
Actually, I'd say I'd tie it with Projectile Vomit
Man.
Yeah,
I would too.
Yeah.
Okay.
I just spoke.
All right, so
actually, I'll
tie
in here.
Let's check the IRC.
And if somebody typed it after that we said it, rat them out, please. Because that's what happened last week. And somebody was typing it in. Okay. Let's see. Critical S gets the first one, Naked Gun.
And Dumb and Dumber.
Dumb and Dumber. And nobody got the other one. That's okay. So Critical S wins, and his prize is we say his name three times. Critical S. Eventually, we will have actual prizes. We do have a stash of prizes here ready to give away. But
we're not giving you any this week, so there.
Yeah, until we get the 1-800. Holy crap, my ears. Until we get the 1-800 number, which has not progressed at all, so I'm going to have to phone AT&T this week and ball them out.
And call them
bastards.
Moronic idiots.
All they have to do is send me a piece of paper in the mail.
I
write on it and send it back, and I've got the number.
That's complicated, man.
It's very complicated.
We don't care. We don't have to. We're the phone company.
Don't allow for lag.
That was a great skit. Who was that anyway?
Lily Tomlin.
Of course,
the modern equivalent would be, we don't care. We don't have to. We're Microsoft.
Yep.
That's right.
Well, who knows? Maybe they may be more companies now.
Yeah, they'll break it up into a bunch of smaller companies each owned by Bill Gates.
That's even better.
Yay, they get to compete with each other.
Or you break it up into a bunch of smaller companies which each have monopolies in their respective subdomains software programming.
Games
right.
Are Us.
Do you know, I really don't, I don't
right.
actually hate,
micro games.
I don't hate Bill Gates. I just find him obtusely fucking boring.
I idolize him.
Everything about him, the whole argument, Bill, shut
rich.
The fuck up. just shut the fuck up, Bill.
Side to the Microsoft monopoly, and that is at least it applies some standards to the industry.
They may be sucky standards, nothing
but
may fucking work, but there is
a standard of brokenness, a standard of perpetual crashdom.
Mm-hmm.
If I hear the quote one more fucking time, oh, the fix is on the patch.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go in the fucking rag and start killing someone.
They just put out Service Pack 6 for Windows NT.
Oh,
and 2 days later, they put out 6A.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Somebody nope. made a typo.
It's amazing. They put out 6 patches so far for the program. It is a very big
People,
program. But
listen, I've said this before. This is me preaching. This is my rant. I know none of you listen to me because I'm an old man and I'm a fucking Luddite. But listen to me. So long as you continue to actually accept this type of standard, as long as you allow yourselves to actually be fucked up the ass, somebody's going to keep grabbing your hips. Okay?
If your house fell down each week, I don't think you'd accept it.
No.
Go
fucking
out and install Linux.
Mm-hmm.
Just basically, the product sucks. Get away from it. Dump it. Drop it. Send them a big fucking figure saying, no, I don't want the fucking patch. I want my fucking money back.
Just remember this. Linux, it is free, and mm-hmm. the software for it is free.
Takes a little bit more knowledge to use it, but once you got it going, it's going for
once
good.
Once you've learned it, WordPerfect is free
on. Oh, Corel's put out their own Linux.
A version of Linux.
Yep.
Oh, really?
That is like much easier to install than normal.
Yeah, all the releases had in the last about 6 to 8 months
have been way better, like
so
leaps and bounds.
Improved their
it auto detects installs. Everything and it just installs everything you want. You just click, all the internet stuff.
There you go.
It's easy now.
I want to learn how to use GIMP because sounds like it's
the ultimate graphics tool.
Yeah, it's just like you
and
know.
It's free. Yeah. You download anything for it. It's all free.
So although I just did the other paper I did was on like this was part of the same one I did. I was working on one on software patents.
Mm-hmm.
It's making me all paranoid about open source now. It's just like, it's going to be gone soon. It's all going to end. It's terrible.
But we'll still copy things just like we do for Windows.
Just like since the dawn of, recordable floppy diskettes.
That's right. We're going to stamp our money now.
Well, actually, even before that, because I remember copying games for my Radio Shack computer. Audio tapes.
People out there who don't know what this is, I've got a little stamp in here, and it stamps www.rantradio.com.
Of course, we don't actually do this, and we do in no way endorse you to do this.
That's right, we're not actually doing this. This is a simulation only.
Simulation with a bunch of paper that sounds just like the type of linen that they use in Canadian dollars.
So,
and
you out there.
It sounds just like a stamp.
Everybody out there, don't grab their pens and don't write www.rantradio.com. And the whole point of this is you win when you get one back. You know that we've proliferated the that's upside down. The money pool.
91,000, cool.
The money pool enough with Rant Radio dollars that we are winning, or something like that. Okay, all mine's done. There's Dak. Stamp his money. I stamped $30 worth of money there.
Just don't give your money to the bank when you're doing this.
No, rip
send it
up.
Directly to us.
Yeah, send it directly to us.
If you find a bill which says Rant Radio,
and
send
you didn't
it to
put it on
us
there?
So that we can prove that you've won the contest, of
yep,
course.
The higher the denomination, the better. Put your name right at the top of the webpage.
Or we will basically not only send your name, I think we actually, for the person who wins this one, we might actually...
Say their name three times.
We'll say their name because there's no way we could fucking prove it and somebody could actually cheat on this one. Yeah. So
somebody stamped, I can't say the name, somebody stamped in and sent the graphic, the picture of about $2,000 in $100 bills stamped American money.
Yowza.
Yep, so I will put that up eventually, but I'm just... really lazy.
I've been noticing the page is about a week behind.
it's actually a week behind today because I didn't put up the update for last week, unfortunately.
We did a lot of nice stuff last week too.
Yeah, it was a really good show last week, unlike this show.
Yeah.
No.
This show's lame.
Aww. Yeah, well, there's only how many of us here right now? Five.
Remember a couple weeks back, we had about five people here,
and it was
amazing. One of our best shows.
Yep.
The only problem
was
that we had
such
egregious technical difficulties. Nobody fucking heard it.
That's right. It was so bad.
Yay.
I don't know what makes it a good show or a bad show. It's the mix of moods. I don't know.
Yep.
It does. I don't.
As you say in the Rant Radio disclaimer.
Yep.
Our brains may have settled between the last show
and this one. Yep. So I've tried to narrow down the formula of what makes a good show, but I just can't get it. So, it just happens. We've had like four shows, good shows in a week in a row.
I think it's something inferior.
Ephemeral.
Thank
ephemeral.
You. I knew somebody would know the word
well,
I was
more
speaking.
More importantly, we've tried nothing to improve the show. It hasn't
true.
Worked.
That is true. We have tried nothing. I'm just trying to find out what makes it good. But
lots
I still haven't found
of,
it.
Lots of really scary-ass stories off of Slashdot usually helps.
True. I haven't been checking Slashdot lately because I've been really busy at work.
What was one of the ones that were saying that Stevie Wonder was thinking
getting new eyeballs?
No.
Yes. He was going to go the Geordi LaForge route here.
No, apparently what has happened is they have come up with a way that they've only tested this in about 31 people. The reason I'm paying attention is because this might actually be able to help me. It has to do with retinal blindness. I have retinitis pigmentosa, so I'm going down the same route eventually that basically we, Stevie Wonder and so many other wonderful people have gone before me.
So if it's good enough for Stevie Wonder, it's good enough for Dak, eh?
Yes. The idea is the chip transmits the information directly from the back of the eye to the optic nerve that goes and then into the brain. That's basically what they're going to do. If it works, they should be able to actually restore some, if not all, of Stevie's sight.
Wow.
Wow. Was Stevie Wonder, has he been blind since birth, or?
No, since basically the age of about 3.
Oh, so he has seen before.
So, yeah, because like...
Not that he would really remember, though.
No, no, but the thing is, though, is that because the way that it works...
I just opened the phone lines, by the way.
If you were to, you know, if you haven't seen before, you know, and then you suddenly start seeing it as an adult, you're not going to be able to understand.
Hi, you're on Rant Radio. Who is this?
Infloop.
Hey, Infloop, how's it going this week?
This week is going fairly well.
Excellent.
Yeah, I'm going to come with talking about another funny-ass story.
Okay.
Okay, this week I wrote the Putnam. Now, what the Putnam is, it's as hard as shit math exam, right?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's basically...
Is this a high school or...
Oh, university.
What? University?
It's, you know, sort of like those competitions in high school, like the Gauss and all those other ones named after some...
some idiot who basically donated the money and started this...
So mindless. I'm writing this exam, right?
Yeah.
And I realized something. I'm a fucking moron. I'm such a total fucking moron. I'm like reading these questions. They're like, find the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and nth derivative of some fucking number.
Yep.
Yeah. So, but there's one thing that makes me feel better.
What's that?
Okay. While I was writing the exam, I was the coach for the exam, the prof. He's supposed to be, like, the number one guy in combinatorics, right?
Okay.
Like, he knows his shit. Yep. I look up, I see this bald guy in his 30s or 40s going, what the fuck is wrong with this? Like, the guy...
Little too hard for him, too, eh?
Yeah, he's, like, all psycho and shit.
Yeah, when your teachers have no fucking idea what the hell you're supposed to be doing, how the fuck are you supposed to know what
exactly.
The fuck you're
yeah,
supposed to be doing?
Yeah, how are they supposed to teach you what they don't know?
Yeah, well, this is a Putnam, however, so...
Yeah, so you're not actually supposed to learn this in school.
Yeah, you're not supposed to know this. Well, it's useless, too. I mean, these questions are like one out of a blue moon. You're never going to see these things ever again. Math stuff.
True.
Yeah, but they're cool to know.
Oh, yeah, they're... Well,
yeah, for math nerds.
I mean,
for math nerds.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that.
If I could crack cryptography in my head,
then it'd be useful. That's right.
Yes.
In between the CIA trying to recruit you, okay,
yeah,
no problem.
Was, yeah.
See, there's another bonus.
Yeah, there's another bonus right there. Oh, and as for earlier, where I talked about the pedophile rant.
Right.
Now, the main reason I know this rant is because one night we were up in the lab working, we're up in the 230 lab, which... It's this hardware wiring course where you have to build a ancient computer from the 60s using 1970s components.
Cool.
So, and we're up there doing an all-nighter trying to understand what this prof said because she speaks in reverse Polish notation, like Yoda. So,
look not to the
okay,
operating system.
So I put on rant. I try to get on rant radio. It doesn't go on. So I just download child porn.
Yep. Child porn rant.
Yeah, the child.
Don't want to get in trouble here.
Child porn.
You're not downloading child porn. It's the child porn rant.
Bad.
Yes.
Child porn is wrong. Bad. Wrong.
Yes. Evil.
So unanimous. Evil. Unanimous cheering.
That's
unanimous
right.
Cheering.
So this got you through the night. This child porn rant.
Security had to come up.
You made that much noise, did you?
Yes, we made that much noise at 1 in the morning.
Good for you. Wake the fuckers up.
So those new rants are on the FTP site.
Yeah, well, this was actually a request from someone else who heard the rant before, though.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So that's why I picked that one.
Right.
That and the one about women.
That one, I like that one about women. It's really good.
The one about women rules.
Oh, yep. Yeah.
So my...
That's yes. That's in the old rants, if anybody wants to get that one.
The new rants are way better.
he's refining his craft.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
They're better produced as well, actually.
Oh, and their standards? Don't follow the standards. There's if you want to know the standards, do a search on RFCs. They're called Requests for Comments.
Right.
Now, what these things are is they tell you how each protocol on the internet works, like how FTP works, how to send fake mail, how the fundamentals of every single protocol. You know what?
What?
If you're dealing with NT or any Microsoft shit, none of them apply.
Because they've changed them.
Well,
to their own liking.
Sort of omitted them, actually.
Omitted them. Just ignored them, did they?
Yeah, well, if you, half the simple mail transfer protocol commands don't work. yeah. And then there's HTML to their own spec, and, well, you can go on and on. But if you want to see the real documents, just go to any search engine, type RFC. And that is it.
Okay.
I was going to do some big, long Linux is good rant.
But we're out of time, unfortunately.
Okay. We're out of time, and I won't want to rack up my phone bill.
Okay.
Okay, say what the hell.
Say what the hell, and we'll hang up on you.
Okay, what the hell.
All right. Thanks for listening this week, and the show is over now.
And so, I'd just like to say it's nice to hear that there are intelligent people out there.
That's right.
There's a few of them. There's
a few of them. Not all the idiots listen.
So we're going to say goodbye to everybody who turned in this week.
XX91X just joined us. So we're going to say goodbye. Yeah.
Say goodbye.
So Dak can say goodbye.
XX91X. Who are these other people on there?
Critical S.
Infaloop.
Mordseth. Next Nat.
Pixie Chick.
Red Five.
Shazboard.
And again, XX91X.
And again, XX91X.
Is there an echo in here?
I don't know. Is there an echo in here?
That's a nice Ed McMahon impression you've been doing there, Dak.
Oh, God.
Steady. That was the best Ed McMahon laugh I could do.
It's on tape.
Just as sincere a laugh.
Is that Santa?
I know there's a horrible connection. It's my computer. I think it's my computer, so I will fix it next week.
His computer has been like
buggy,
and glitchy.
The last three times.
Hideous.
Yes.
It's possessed. Okay.
It's possessed.
It sounds remarkably like you've got a bad connection, but
it's not. It's me.
It sounds that bad from here.
Our connections are fine. I'm going to uninstall the real media that I installed.
Get rid of
3 weeks
media.
Ago.
Real media
that
is
happened
evil.
To coincide with the time that it got started getting bad.
You mean the bad stuff started when you put this thing on, and it might have something to do with it?
Yes.
Wow.
Real
yeah.
media,
problem
you
solving.
Mean that thing where they're using your bandwidth to send back information about your computer, which you never agreed to give to
them?
That's
the company. That's right.
Wow.
Fuck them.
Gee, fuck you em. Don't imagine fuck that would be causing some problems.
Nope. So we're going to all say goodbye here, starting from the left to the right. So, Projectile Vomit Man, be saying goodbye. Wow. Did that
sounded
wake,
more like a death rattle.
Did that wake your parents? It's a death rattle. Wow, it would be funny to get all these. I think I'm going to do that. That would take a long time. But eventually, I will get them from all the shows and put them all in order.
What makes me nervous is the fact that my hand is like right there, and he's making these noises, right? Like, because I'm handing over my mic.
You never know what that might induce.
Yes.
And goodbye from
the girl on the left.
Big wave to everyone out there. Yay! And next up is
Black Wolf
saying goodbye.
This is Dak saying so long and fuck y'all.
And this is Sumerian saying goodbye for. This week and next week, we will probably have Drexel for the good or worse.
Of whatever happened tonight.
And I will play the outro as soon as my computer stops. Where's my
so
mouse?
Long. Farewell.
There it is.
I hope we see again.
And here's the outro. Till next week. Bye-bye from Rant Radio and What the Hell, Sunday nights at 9 p.m. Be here next week. Tell all your friends. Forward the ICU. Spam everyone. Now.
What the hell?
You have just listened to another episode of What the Hell on Rant Radio. Tune in next Sunday at 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time to find out what happened to Sim and the rest of the gang in the dramatic continuation of What the Hell.
Shut up!
Can I leave now?
To basically not control children of that age?